Welcome to ESPN Saturday Night Football, presented by Windows. And for tonight's Big Ten matchup between Wisconsin and Ohio State, the stars are out. LeBron James and the world champion Miami Heat. You are looking live at a sold-out Ohio Stadium in Columbus, Ohio, for the much-anticipated showdown. The undefeated Buckeyes host division rival Wisconsin, a game with both national championship and Rose Bowl implications. Good evening, everybody. With Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brett Musburger. At halftime, Alabama leads Mississippi by 3 field goals. But the bigger picture in the SEC, can they play any defense in that conference?
It's amazing. It seems like there are shootouts every single week. But you got to give Georgia a lot of credit. Big win. That's the second big win they've had against South Carolina. Now, of course, today against LSU. And it's going to inch them up. They did what they needed to do today.
Now it'll be the Buckeyes' turn to move center stage. Meanwhile, the coaches, Gary Anderson on the left against his old head coach, Urban Meyer.
Yeah, it is a big opportunity, as you said, for Ohio State, and a big opportunity for Wisconsin and Gary Anderson, the first-year head coach. Of course, he worked with Urban back in 2004 at Utah, that magical run that the Utes had that ended up landing Urban Meyer in Florida. So they're familiar with one another and respect one another quite a bit.
Yeah, folks, here's a scoop. The Badgers have some running backs.
Boy, every year it seems like Wisconsin has a tandem of backs, and this year might be some of the best they've had. James White, the guy who's a veteran, a senior, leads the nation in career rushing yards. You can see his style, very different from Melvin Gordon. His quickness, low center of gravity, he can break through arm tackles. Melvin Gordon, they've in the past got him on the perimeter, like this jet sweep. They love to get him to the edge. He's averaging over 11 yards a carry. He's improved. He's gotten stronger. They like to run in between the tackles. Ohio State, I think, will load up against that running game and see if they can force Wisconsin and Joel Stavi to throw the ball to win.
Now, Herbie, the big question on everybody's mind, what about Buckeye quarterback Braxton Miller? You spoke to Urban Meyer.
Yeah, I just talked to Urban right before we came on the air, and he said that there's no question. Braxton Miller's healthy. He's had a great week of practice. With all due respect to what Kenny Guyton has been able to accomplish, this is Braxton Miller's team. He's a three-year starter. They're confident ability to run and throw. They feel that they can put a lot of pressure on this Wisconsin defense. Look for Braxton Miller to try to exploit Wisconsin going through the air over the top.
And Herbie, you never get tired of this scene. The Ohio State marching band when it's time to dot the I. Columbus.
The Nissan pregame rush with John Saunders and Jesse Palmer is next after this message and a word from our ABC stations.
Now the script's about to kick off. This party looks whack. Let's take it back to straight hip hop and start it from scratch. I'm about to bloody this track up. Everybody get back. That's why my opinions have had, because my rhymes are.
Welcome back to ESPN Saturday Night Football, presented by Windows. The third member of our crew, Heather Cox, down below with Ohio State coach Urban Meyer. Now we go to Heather.
Brett, thanks so much. Coach, you told us you can't remember working so hard to prepare for a game. What makes this one so tricky?
Well, they have a good running game. They have a good defense. They run some things that you have to work, get yards against them. You better tackle these backs.
And you have two great quarterbacks, Braxton Miller back from injury as your starter. What gives you the confidence that he's your go-to guy tonight?
Well, he's got 12 games from last year. This year, he had a great Thursday practice. He's ready to go.
Irvin, enjoy it. Thank you. Brent?
Thank you, Heather. Ohio State won the toss and deferred, so Gary Anderson and the Badgers will handle the ball first. And folks, I can't remember the last time I was in Columbus for a night that is this beautiful out. I mean, it's 70 degrees. It has been balmy for the last 3 days here.
Well, yeah, that's what you told me the old hometown.
Great. What
did Urban say it's like this every day? Right? Did he say that?
Absolutely.
So now Joel Stabbe, and he becomes a very, very key man in this game here tonight with this running attack.
You're exactly right. Ohio State's defense has got to be geared up to stop the running tandem of James White and Melvin Gordon. They'll cheat their safeties up, and Stabbe has to play well with the play-action pass and try to stretch the Ohio State defense with the passing game. They may have to pass to set up the running game tonight.
Gordon starts as the Badger running back. Top end speed, power eye low. Here comes 2-5. About a 3-yard gain and hit by C.J. Barnett, one of the safeties. And we take a look, Kirby, at one of our matchups here tonight.
Yeah, we're going to keep an eye on James White. Melvin Gordon just talked about the importance of what Ohio State's going to try to do to stop this running game. Ryan Shazier, number 10, Christian Bryant. You also just saw, as Brent said, C.J. Barnett. Both the safeties will be physical and active, but they better be careful. The passing game with Jared Averderis, number 4. They love to get him isolated one-on-one.
White checks in. Play action. Here's Stabbe. Didn't fool the rush man. Couldn't get back to the line of scrimmage, and that's Barnett again all over the field. Is number 4. He's out of Dayton, Ohio.
Yeah, a fine player, a veteran player, and very, very active in the back end of the Ohio State defense. They need his leadership. First play, you saw him in run defense. That time, he didn't bite on the play action in perfect position as Wisconsin tried to roll out and hit the tight end.
Shotgun look for the first time tonight. Needs 8 yards. Not going to get it. 3 and out. Forced to punt. Bradley Roby. Keep an eye on him. You folks who like to see NFL prospects, number 1 will someday be playing Sunday football.
And that's the matchup tonight. Bradley Roby, an All-American corner, up tight in coverage against Averderis. A good throw, but the left hand of Roby gets in there to knock that football away. Tight coverage. He walked up tight on him because of the confidence that he has. That's a big play there on third down.
Corey Brown back deep. Drew Meyer will punt it. Going to go out of bounds, and the Buckeyes are going to have outstanding field position. So here comes the return of Braxton Miller, missing a couple of games and most of the third when he was injured against San Diego State. And here comes number 5. You folks remember he finished 5th in the Heisman voting a year ago.
Yeah, and with Urban Meyer's offense where they spread you out with 3, sometimes 4 receivers, Braxton Miller is known as a runner. Tonight, Ohio State's going to see if he can throw the ball downfield against his Wisconsin defense.
And his starter is the powerful number 34, Carlos Hyde. To get it to the outside against his veteran defense. A tremendous second effort, picking up about 5 yards. Armstrong hitting first, and he just kept moving. And our impact matchup here looks this way, Irby.
Yeah, Devin Smith and Corey Brown. You're also going to see the true freshman, Dontre Wilson, who they'll try to stretch down the field. It puts a lot of pressure on the corners of Wisconsin.
Braxton rolls, first pass, complete, first down, and out of bounds is Jeff Heirman.
Brent, we seem to see this every week. Not only have to deal with the X's and O's in the scheme, but the tempo of it, noticing the formation, getting it lined up, getting the call, and playing fast as a defense. Ohio State wants to take some shots early. We'll see if Wisconsin's ready to defend it downfield in the pass game.
And the pistol look. Hide up the middle. Another first down to the 25-yard line. Buckeyes threatening.
Chris Borland right here, one of the best linebackers in the country. He's respecting the passing game. You see his eyes? He's looking out to the tight end that's flexed out. They ran right where he was vacated.
Keeps it. Fires. End zone. Touchdown, Buckeyes. Evan Spencer. Braxton Miller is healthy, folks.
Going to double check to make sure he had possession of the ball all the way through. They ran the football, and then it sets up the play action where the safeties and linebackers have to respect it, and they got behind it for a big play.
DeBaso knocks down the extra point. Less than 3 minutes into our showdown. Buckeyes force a three and out and then strike first on this pass to Spencer. Welcome back, number five. Scenes in college football here in Columbus at the Shoe. 55 yards, four plays. Buckeyes strike first. It away. This time they'll take a knee and come out in the 25.
Back to the touchdown. Ohio State had a wheel route right here from Philly Brown. And here's Evan Spencer, who's going to go to the post. And it really puts the true freshman, Shelton, in no man's land. Look at this route form. You're going to go here, going to come down here, and look at the indecision from the true freshman. What are you going to do? I don't care if you're a senior. Who are you going to cover? You've got two guys. They flood the zone. There's nothing he can do. Here's a great look at, who do I take? Do I take the guy to the outside? Whichever way he was going to go, Brent, Braxton Miller was going to go in the other direction. Well-designed play and executed perfectly that time by the junior quarterback.
So both running backs are now on the field. The jet sweep, a big part of the offense, and here he comes, Gordon. Here's their first jet sweep, and they crush it. And that is Roby. They're going to attack with the corners, and the linebacker is going to engage the pulling lineman. And Herbie, that was perfect that time.
It looks like he's holding his back there. You're right. They've looked at this all week because Wisconsin doesn't have the vertical passing game. They'll stretch you horizontally with the jet sweep. That's one of the ways they try to go after a defense. You can see Roby didn't even make it to the sidelines. He had to take a knee here.
And Reeves has checked in. Armani Reeves. A sophomore, and that'd be a huge loss if he's out for much time.
Well, he's one of the top corners in the country. He was holding his back as he came off the field. You don't see one of the top cover corners as willing to come up and run support as Bradley Roby. That's the second time tonight already he's coming up and being very physical at the point of attack.
NFL scouts who are here note that.
No doubt about that. And I will say that you said they're attacking with the linebackers and with the corners. I'll go back to what I said early. Stavi's going to have to make a play or two down the field, whether it's a tight end or Abrederis. Right now, Ohio State seems to be defending about 5 yards down the field and closer to the line of scrimmage. They're not respecting anything vertically, and they're tightening up their coverage.
Now, Jared Abrederis does not have Roby on him now. So let's see if the Badgers... They're going to run it right straight ahead, and a penalty flag is thrown by the umpire down into the pit area.
Holding. Offense. Number 79. distance to the goal. Second down.
Ryan Groy locks in with Joel Hale. Wisconsin needs to avoid. C 79 right in the middle of your screen. Just pulls Hale down. Officials all over that. And Brett, we're early in this game. Ohio State's going to decline it to set up third down. It's early in this game, but I don't know about you. This is important early in the game for Wisconsin to weather the storm and the emotions of this atmosphere and not dig themselves such a big hole early in this game.
Absolutely. Anderson and the Badgers face a third and 14. Stavi goes and is short and complete. Abrederis, the intended target. And another punt coming up for the Badgers.
Ohio State knows that Stavi loves to look up Jared Abrederis, his only true threat as a wide receiver. He's going to come from the right to the left. Watch Ohio State. They have him from the outside with Grant and also on the inside with Reeves, the nickel. They took him kind of from the outside in case he went to the outside, but across the middle, the other corner, playing a robber there, took it away.
Corey Brown again deep for the Buckeyes. Remember, they had only 55 yards to negotiate last time. This one takes a little bit of a Badger bounce. And this one closer to the 30-yard line. A little bit better for that Badger D. You're watching ESPN Saturday Night Football on ABC.
Saturday Night Football presented by Windows. Brought to you by Windows. Liberty Mutual Insurance. Responsibility. What's your policy? And Buick. Visit your local Buick dealer to see why thousands of people are switching to Buick.
Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned, making tires that go the distance, inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Now the Wisconsin offensive line, wide receivers trying to regroup. They have been dominating. Minus two total yards with two series in the book. Here come the Buckeyes again. Fumble and out of bounds. Ohio State football. Dontre Wilson, the freshman out of DeSoto, Texas, was the ball carrier.
Very, very different style of runner from what you will see from Carlos Hyde. Much more quickness and acceleration to the edge. They like to put him in the slot, hand him the football, and also will try to get him isolated one-on-one because he's a great receiver, too. Going to look over from time to time to get that confirmation. They want to go fast.
Second and four, and Hyde picks his way. And speaking of the NFL, folks, keep an eye on number 34. 6 foot, 235 pounds. He's a senior from Naples. One thing you look for when you're running back in the NFL is toughness. And he has got that. Play action. Rolling. Steps out of bounds at the line of scrimmage.
And toughness, and he surprises you with his athletic ability. He's known as a power back, but look at this. Oh, this is Braxton Miller, but the play before, Carlos Hyde had such quickness and vision where he was patient, and he'll surprise you with his acceleration through the hole.
Second and 11. Here is Hyde. Second effort. Picks up another yard as he crosses midfield that time. And Chris Borland, number 44, right there. He'll be in on a lot of tackles as he has been throughout his career with the Badgers.
One of yours and my favorite players in the country.
Absolutely.
From Ohio, went to Kettering Alder High School down in Dayton. Grew up a Badger fan, not an Ohio State fan.
Third down and seven of the penalty flag, and false start, I believe, is the call here against the Buckeyes.
False start. Offense. Number 78, 5-yard penalty. Third down.
Left guard Andrew Norwell moved a little bit early. This is a senior offensive line, Herbie, and the coach when we said, are you going to play some of the youngsters? No way. We're going all the way with these guys. Winning the game is everything.
No doubt about it. Full steam ahead. You're right, four seniors, a veteran bunch up there. It's a big third down for both teams, but especially Wisconsin's defense early in this game.
Third and 12. the pressure. Braxton, great escapability, dances, and he will not get close to the first down. There is another penalty flag, however, thrown by the line judge coming off the Ohio State sideline.
There is no foul on the play for ineligible receiver downfield. Fourth down.
Brent, Chris, so the Badgers will get it back, Herbie.
Yeah, you just talked about Chris Borland, and what they'll do on third down is move him to a pass rusher. They walk him up on the edge here, and watch what he does here with his quickness going up against a huge right tackle in Decker. He's spin move. Now watch, he doesn't give up on the play. He's going to chase his play down and get to Braxton Miller and make him throw it away. That's 44 right there in a nutshell.
So Kenzel Doe is out. And that means Jared Aberderis will be back to receive this punt. Very sure-handed. Probably plays without that game-breaking, play-breaking ability of Kenzel Doe, so they will miss that. But they've got a sure-handed one back. And here is Aberderis. And he does make the catch at the 9-yard line. A reminder, NASCAR's best continue the drive for the championship. Our points leader, Matt Kenseth, speaking of Wisconsin, is now 2-for-2 in the chase for the Sprint Cup and has lengthened his points lead. Don't miss the NASCAR Sprint Cup Series at Dover tomorrow, 1 p.m. Eastern on ESPN. And also live on Watch ESPN. There's your point standing. Kyle Busch and Jimmy Johnson's lurking.
Wisconsin has run 6 plays, and 5 of them for either 0 or negative yards. Said it earlier, Ohio State is stacking the line here. Let's see if Stavi has an answer by throwing the ball, or if they can open up a crease here for these backs.
Well, Gordon is going to try it as the eye back now. They'll see what he can do behind this veteran line. Dan Foltz is your center tonight. Lou Allen is out with an injury. Foltz is a redshirt freshman, number 70. And nothing doing and swarming all over him is Shazier. Ryan Shazier from Fort Lauderdale went to Plantation High School, wanted to come north to play football.
And he does a good job of attacking through the interior of that Wisconsin offensive line. Michael Bennett doing a good job of fighting off the blocks up front as well. But it's Shazier's quickness and instincts there that make the play.
Second down and 11. Caught for a first down. Beautiful play that time. And they get it on over to the sideline to Alex Erickson as we check in now with Robert Flores for our first update of the night.
All right, Brent, Dr. Pepper 10 conference update from the SEC. Alabama led Ole Miss by 9-0 at the half. Nick Saban was hulking up on the sideline at his players. Then in the second half, T.J. Yeldon, long touchdown run. Alabama on top, 16-0 over Ole Miss on ESPN.
All right, keep an eye on that one for us. And here, Buckeyes lead by 7. Gordon is the eye back. Play action to him. Stavi rolls over to the right. Fires downfield, complete again. And suddenly, that's Aberderis. And Herbie, suddenly, the passing game is starting to work on the sideline.
Yeah, they have to throw the ball to set up this running game. They've got to get Ohio State safety and linebackers back deeper. 2 good calls, play action there. There's his man, Aberderis, against the All-American corner, Bradley Roby. You can see the timing. They're in sync there, and a good ball away from Roby, and an outstanding route that time by Aberderis to get away from Roby.
Ball out to the 41, so breathing room for the Badger offense finally. Now they come with that running game. And Gordon. And that was a good hole on that right side. Grant came up from his cornerback spot.
Yeah, you throw the football, you hit a couple play-action passes, and then you're able to have balance. You go back to your bread and butter, take some of the pressure off of the big fellas up front. The double team works. They push Michael Bennett right out. Look at that big block by the tight end. He locks up with Noah Spence, and Spence ends up on his back.
Second down and 2. Melvin Gordon from Kenosha, Wisconsin, stays right there in the backfield. Gonna run for it. Got the first down easy. Daylight, he is so dangerous.
He's a back that if he finds just a little crease, he can one cut you and go. I mean, he's not going to get 10 or 15. He's going to pick up everything.
And Herbie, when you were in charge of the tape machine, you couldn't get over how graceful he was cutting.
You know, I hate to say an Eric Dickerson kind of back, but he reminds you with his skill set and his style of running of that kind of back. I played with a guy named Robert Smith. He's kind of that type of back. Just long strides and covers a lot of ground.
So now James White. Another youngster from Fort Lauderdale, Florida. He checks into that backfield. Play action, stopping covered, and still is able to get it off underneath to Sam Arneson, one of the tight ends. Stavi was under enormous pressure. This was a very good play by the quarterback.
And Andy Ludwig, the offensive coordinator from Wisconsin, and the head coach, Gary Anderson, making some adjustments, going back to what we talked about. If you can't just line up and pound a defense that has 8-9 defenders up close to the line of scrimmage. You've got to take some chances, break some trends, throw on early downs with play action. Then you can really get into sync and a rhythm as an offense.
J.J. Watt's brother, Derek Watt, is number 34. He's the fullback in front of White. And there's a penalty flag. That was before the snap.
Looks like the left guard may have jumped their groin.
Full start. Offense. Number 79.
That's twice. 5-yard
penalty. Second down.
He's a senior.
They've got some new personnel up front, and Goy has been their most consistent offensive lineman. One thing you can always count on in Madison, big, strong offensive linemen and talented running backs. That's their bread and butter. But as we're seeing tonight, Stavi's making enough plays through the air off the play action to help them.
He may be moving on the G and the rest of them moving on the O.
That's right.
That's how good he is.
That's right.
Second down and 7.
Wisconsin trying to get a timeout.
And here comes White. Cut left. They saw something, and now, because they did not get a timeout in time, they're going to have a third down and long coming up against this Buckeye defense.
This is what they wanted to avoid, third down and long situations. Everybody on the Ohio State defense aware of Jared Aberderis and his ability to make plays, but give Wisconsin and Gary Anderson a lot of credit, making some adjustments and breaking some tendencies by trying to get the ball to some other folks in these situations.
Need 6 yards. Need to reach the 30-yard line for a first down. Buckeyes show blitz. Stavi in the middle. Fires for it. Aberderis. Great catch by Aberderis. Touchdown, Badgers. Oh, what a grab under pressure.
On third down, they want to go to number 4. It's a wheel route, and look who he's going up against. Bradley Roby, and he's locked up. He doesn't get much separation. That ball was perfectly thrown by Stavi. A great throw, an area that he's been working so hard to improve. Pretty good coverage by Roby, but the ball was just perfectly thrown there on third down by Stavi.
Yeah, I thought he had a one-handed grab on it with Roby all over him. 36 yards. Remember now, that was a 3rd and 6. And Endicott tacks in the extra point. This youngster's a gamer.
No doubt about it. Never gave up on the route. Perfect throw and a great catch.
The passing game is alive and well for the Badgers here. I mean, yep. We are deadlocked at 7. Well, the college football bus is here in Columbus. And a reminder that tailgate week fired up by Kingsford Charcoal. Coming up next weekend, so come along with us to Evanston, Illinois. Mr. Herb Street, Northwestern and Ohio State.
What a game. What a game. Let's go back. You talked about it. He's got getting held there by Roby. It looked like maybe a one-handed catch. Perfect throw. He does end up getting the left hand back to help him out. But Jared Aberderis, pound for pound, one of the best receivers in college football.
Dontre Wilson and Jordan Hall. Back deep for the Buckeyes. Fielded at the 5 by Wilson. The freshman spins. And out to the 26-yard line. Nice return. Well, there's your two quarterbacks, and because Miller was injured, Kenny Guyton picked him up in the San Diego State game and then two outstanding starts while Braxton was recovering.
It's a big debate here locally who should be the starter. It's Braxton Miller's team, clearly, for anybody on the inside of this program. But Kenny Guyton deserves a ton of credit. A captain, did everything that's been asked, always has a positive attitude. Urban Meyer says next year he'd love to have him as a GA and be on this staff. He thinks that highly of him.
Big hole for Hyde. Powers for 12 yards and first down.
And this is the back that they've missed. Jordan Hall's done a nice job, but not just the quickness, but he has such a feel for this offense and how they want to attack. And, of course, not just the quickness, but the power to go along with it.
Flag, false start again.
False start. Offense, number 78, 5-yard penalty, first down.
Check it down below now with Heather Cox.
Guys, I talked to Braxton Miller about how he was going to keep that left knee healthy. He told me he's wearing what's called the playmaker knee brace. You can't really see it. It was important to Braxton that it was covered up. Now, it's a neoprene sleeve with hinges on both sides that keeps him from hyperextended. He said that's the one area it's still bothering him when it overstraightens, guys.
We pound again with Hyde. Russell down after a few yards. Borland, number 44, in on that tackle. So what else is new?
He's going to be involved in a lot of tackles in the middle of that defense. He's going to have to do everything, whether it's, you know, Heather's report, Braxton Miller running the football. Right now we're seeing a lot of Carlos Hyde, already six carries here in his first quarter.
Second down and 10. Complete. To be third down and short. Corey Brown, the receiver that time, and Peniel Jean making the stop for the Badgers.
Right now, Wisconsin's playing a defense that is just trying to, they're off on their corners at the receivers. They're respectful of the deep ball. They're trying to keep everything in front of them, making Ohio State try to execute in front, and then they've got a gang tackle with Borland leading the way.
Miller back to pass on third down. And it's first and 10 for the Buckeyes as they work again with Corey Brown, the senior from Upper Darby, Pennsylvania. Smart youngster.
Well, you see, watch Chris Borland in the middle of this defense. He's outside, he's inside, he's reading the quarterback's eyes, and he got over there just a little bit late. And there's where Braxton Miller's really trying to make strides. His primary receiver was covered. He came off of him, patiently sat in the pocket, and eventually found his open man for the first down.
With the read option, pulls it back and throws out of it and gets it complete now to Wilson, the freshman, and out of bounds as the Buckeyes threaten again.
They brought him out of the backfield. They had Carlos Hyde and Dontre Wilson in the backfield, and they just slid him out. Another wheel route, way running to the boundary, and then you cut down the field, and he got lost in coverage in a pretty easy read and throw that time for Braxton.
Braxton is 5 of 6 here in the first quarter. He's thrown for one touchdown. Just shy of the 25-yard line. Play action. Strike for the end zone. Touchdown. His second touchdown strike of the night. This time it's Devin Smith, the junior from Massillon, Ohio.
It's the chance you have to take to try to stop the running game. Is leave your corners on an island. Urban Meyer and Tom Herman recognizing that. They got Braxton Miller back off of the play action. And he threw a backside deep ball there to Devin Smith. And the corner, Gene, just didn't have much of a chance to even locate the football.
Drew Basil tacks on the extra point.
There's still questions, you think, about Braxton Miller's ability to throw the football around the...
Not with what we're looking at here tonight so far.
He can throw it. You don't have to worry about that.
What do we got brewing here? A shootout?
Could be.
44 seconds remaining in the first quarter. Big Ten opener for Ohio State and the second Big Ten game of the season for the Badgers, who beat up on Purdue last week in Madison. Badgers will take next week off and await the Northwestern Wildcats. The Wildcats will go to Madison following their game at Evanston next week against Ohio State. Braxton Miller off to a red-hot start. He's 6 of 7, 95 yards and 2 touchdowns. And so Zuleger comes out. And Kyle Zuleger is out across the 20-yard line.
It's the play action to Hyde freezes the linebackers, the safeties. Musso's up there. Now he tries to retreat. By now it's too late. They've left Gene on an island. And look where the ball's thrown away from Gene. Intentionally thrown in that way where he knows he's got him downfield, but he throws it away towards the sidelines where Devin Smith adjusts to the ball. And Gene, again, never saw the football. By the time he saw it, it was already in the arms and for a touchdown for Devin Smith.
James White dashes out as the running back. He's the active career-leading rusher in the nation. Over 3,000 yards in his career with the Badgers. Play action. Stoppy buys time. Fires to a wide-open Abreu Daris. They turn him loose. 35, 30, 25. Foot race and finally out of bounds. And he was in a race with C.J. Barnett.
The play action freezes the linebackers and safeties. You see, they still have their nose up there. Look at this. You see, Frederick goes right by the safety. Again, Ohio State still in a defense to take away the running game, and they're leaving themselves in a very vulnerable position. Play action. Look at the linebackers come up. Now they start to bail. Their heads are on the swivel. They're looking everywhere, and they can't get back. They've got everybody at the line of scrimmage. All they've heard about is James White and Melvin Gordon. They're going to force Wisconsin to throw, and Wisconsin's done their homework. They've been prepared. Stavi, 6 of 8 for 140 yards.
Because there was 64 of those yards on that pass play. Any questions about Stavi's pass play?
No way.
All right, we'll be back after this message and a word from your local ABC stations. All presented by Windows. The second quarter, and while you were away, John Cooper in the 1993 Buckeye team introduced, man, Big Daddy Wilkerson, Joey Galloway, some players I well remember, Herbie. Melvin Gordon now will open the second quarter as a running back.
Another time.
False start.
The right guard.
False start. Offense. Number 54. 5-yard penalty. First down.
Costigan.
Yeah, this is the loudest part of the stadium. And I think he anticipated the snap count. Tried to get an early jump there. These are the kind of errors clearly Wisconsin needs to avoid. But this is a big drive. I mean, Wisconsin got down 7, came back with an answer. Down 7 again. Another big opportunity after the pass play to Abreu Daris to try to get more points on the board here.
And with that running game behind the left side to see if they can't get something going down here. Bryant up to help on that stop of Gordon. And, you know, Melvin Gordon came into this game averaging 11.8 yards a rush. That's right. You heard me right, okay? Well, here tonight, as he goes off after being banged up, he's rushed for 21 yards with 6 carries, a little over 3 yards a carry. So a little bit different kind of defense that he's looking at here tonight. And James White replaces it. Play action, Stavi rolling, White's covered, looks end zone, fires. Abreu Daris was out of bounds.
Stavi, this time, one of the few mistakes he makes, play action again. Of course, that's what they need to do. Abreu Daris works on a double move, gets to the outside right there. If he throws it now, he's got a chance. Just late with the football. He waited to see him open, and then he threw. If he could have just thrown it just a little bit early, Abreu Daris had Roby beat again to the corner.
Take another look now at Gordon going out of the game.
Right on the helmet of Christian Bryant.
Third down and 11. Trying to flex that right shoulder. Fires on the slant, incomplete. Abadaris the target. Roby tracking Abadaris. The coaches said, we want one-on-one. We want Roby on Abadaris.
Well, right now, the advantage in that matchup goes to Wisconsin. Abadaris has made some big plays in this game and won a lot of times against, again, one of the top corner cover corners in the country. Got to the inside that time, but Wisconsin unable to execute and convert.
So Kyle French will attempt this 32-yard field goal. Too far left. Buckeyes lead it by 7. A beautiful night in Columbus. Buckeyes lead 14-7, and Heather Cox is down below with the chosen one, LeBron James. Heather?
Thanks so much, Brent. I think the biggest Buckeye fan I've ever seen. High-fiving players when they're coming off. LeBron, you've been on the sideline. You've talked to the team beforehand. What kind of advice were you able to give them?
Just letting them understand how important team is. You know, this is all about team, and no matter how big one individual may be over the other, in order to get the ultimate goal, it has to be about team, and that's what I wanted to relate to the kids.
We all see you on the basketball court, but a lot of people also know you were quite the football star in high school, a wide receiver. How antsy to get being this close to the action? How much do you want to get out there and play?
I love the sport. I've always said I love the sport more than basketball. So it just gets me going again. It takes me back to Friday Night Lights when I was in high school, and just being here to support this unbelievable university, this unbelievable football team. Coach Urban Meyer, welcomed me with open arms, and I'm happy to be here.
And your job does start on Monday. You actually go to the Bahamas to open up, fall camp, to open up training camp. In your mind, what's the priority for the Miami Heat this year?
For us, it's a process. We can't skip, to the playoffs. We have to take each and every day like it's our last opportunity to get better. And if we stay healthy, we're going to give ourselves a good chance to win.
And a big month for you, LeBron. Congratulations. You and Savannah got married on September 14th. How was the big day?
It was awesome. It was a big celebration. For me and Savannah, and also to have your greatest loved ones and your friends and family there, it was unbelievable. And, it went too fast, I'll tell you that.
Hate to tell you, the honeymoon's over. Back to work on Monday. We're looking forward to seeing you on the hardwood. LeBron, thanks as always.
All right, thank you.
And Heather, tell him that Pat Riley just docked him a few grand for saying he liked football better than basketball. what a great superstar and a great citizen he's turned out to be, too. First down passed out by Braxton Miller. He, of course, Herbie is from Akron, Ohio, and he's given an awful lot of money back to St. Mary's High School, over $1 million. He's bought uniforms for all the teams up there. He stays in touch with the kids when they get good grades. He sends out an email and congratulates.
Yeah, he is very loyal to Akron, St. Vincent, St. Mary, and even when he left the Cavs, he maintained that relationship. And just when people in Ohio see LeBron James, they still see him in that high school uniform where he used to sell out the Schottenstein Center, coming in to play in the state championship games from his freshman year all the way up to his senior year.
First down and 10 for the Buckeyes, who are up by 7. Braxton Miller going to go deep. Man's covered, incomplete. It'll be second down and long. Evan Spencer, who caught one of the touchdown passes, was working against the freshman Shelton, who is also from Fort Lauderdale. We had a lot of youngsters out of Fort Lauderdale in this football game.
Great coverage by Sojourn Shelton. You just talked about where he's from. Stride for stride. He's had a couple plays where receivers have gotten behind him. It's a true freshman on an island against a veteran player in Devin Smith. He's got to be able to hold up tonight. That time, stride for stride, and a great play there, trying to get deep to knock that ball away.
So the Buckeyes will see if they can come back now on second and third, move the chains here. Miller hands it off, and Hyde, he is the workhorse running back tonight, number 34, no question about that. He's rushed for over 50 yards already in the first half, and that is going to bring up about a third down and 5, it looks like.
Wisconsin doing a good job of rotating defensive linemen and trying to stay fresh against his tempo.
Braxton Miller short of the first down. Superb tackle by Connor O'Neill, a fifth-year senior up the road from Fort Lauderdale, Delray Beach, Florida.
Well, Urban Meyer's already gone for fourth downs this year 12 times and has made 10 of them. He doesn't hesitate at all here, and right away sends out the extra tight end. Looks like he wants to, we got a flag down. That's what Urban's looking for here.
When they start to do that, folks, they think there are too many men on the field.
Yeah.
I think you read Gary's lips where there are 12 exactly. men.
Flag comes in late.
There
like
is
that.
No foul on the play for an illegal substitution. Fourth down.
Gary Anderson kind of stating his case there.
You must beware of Urban Meyer and the fake punts. They're across midfield, and I know some guys would not say that.
He's going to go.
He's not even going to worry about a punter. Give me high.
That's right. 10 of 12 coming into tonight.
Here he goes. Can you bring him offside with a hard count? Motion, maybe that'll work.
Call the timeout. Yeah. Disciplined by Wisconsin. They didn't jump. Remember, he's gone for it already in four games, 12 times on fourth down. That's a great job by Wisconsin of holding their spot there. Gary Anderson's got to be proud of his crew showing a lot of discipline there.
I think Coach Anderson's out there reminding them, which because they backed off of that. Make sure you're alert out there. There's been some unbelievable fake punts in college football so far this year. The Badgers pulled one of them. They brought Borland on an end around, handed it to him with everybody moving to the left, and he threw for a first down coming over to the right. There was another youngster who pooch punted to a teammate behind the line of scrimmage. Now there's the fake punt with Borland earlier. We've seen direct snaps to up backs. We've seen a little bit of everything. Let's see what Urban's got up his sleeve tonight. He's very much in charge of special teams and has been at Bowling Green, Utah, Florida, and now here at Ohio State.
The equalizer Gary Anderson coached with him in 04, so he may know a few of his secrets.
They're going to punt it away. Fair catch with Akrideris. The sure-handed one. Back of the eight. Well, Big Ten champion, of course, goes to the Rose Bowl. The Buckeyes want to go to the Rose Bowl, but a week after the Rose Bowl game, they want to go to the championship game.
Saturday Night Football presented by Windows. Brought to you by Degree. It won't let you down. Ford. Only Ford gives you EcoBoost fuel economy and a whole lot more. And UPS. Let UPS put the power of logistics to work for you.
Well, here in Columbus, Ohio, our scene, of course, at Ohio State opened back in 1922. Had a seating capacity at that time of 66,000. Now seats more than 105,000. And every seat occupied here tonight for the showdown against the Badgers, who will move to another Big Ten division, the West, next year. So they will not play the Buckeyes every year. James White is now in as Coach Anderson's running back, and Gordon's back in the game with the fly sweep from the end zone. Stavi complete, and not much doing for James White. Hit behind the line of scrimmage for a loss that time. Spence was in there defensively.
They actually dropped Spence, one of their better pass rushers, dropped him in coverage, and he does a very good job of staying home. Now remember, he's a big defensive end that rushes quarterbacks, 255 pounds. The coverage called for him to drop, clearly saw the screen being designed and was there to be able to sniff it out.
Second and 12. Gordon gets a crease. First down to the 23-yard line and out of bounds, Melvin Gordon.
Ohio State had penetration. They just got lost. I mean, you had two guys that had a chance. That's a design cutback, and Gordon has great vision. But Andy Ludwig noticing Ohio State putting some pressure, blitzing some folks, and they got in there quickly, but they did not adjust and maybe underestimated the quickness and suddenness that time of Melvin Gordon, the sophomore.
James White now in, and he comes right up the middle behind Volts. And let us check in with Robert Flores for an update. Robert.
Hey, Brent, this week Floyd Mayweather said he bet $300,000 on A&M to beat Arkansas. Things are getting a little tight. Alex Collins, the touchdown run. Number 10, A&M, 31-27 over Arkansas.
If he gave the points, he's in trouble. Second down, Melvin Gordon. Play action. Stabby looking downfield all the time, and he's hit on the release. If it was a fumble, it was covered up. Michael Bennett was in on top of him, and Costigan, the right guard, I believe, number 54, got on that loose football.
Yeah, that ball was out. Michael Bennett has had a pretty big night. When they've isolated one-on-one, he's look at him fight to get through there. The back Gordon tries to help out, but he got to that football before it got out of the hands of Stabby. And an alert offensive lineman. How about the big fella Costigan going airborne to bring that one down? He's asking a lot of the 315-pound right guard.
Third down and 11. James White's the running back. Stabby steps away from pressure and completes the pass to Abradaris. That is beautiful quarterbacking work. Andy Ludwig did a great job of teaching this youngster. If you feel it, step up in it. And this is hard to do, folks, when you watch this replay.
Holding.
Oh, coming back. That's too bad. It was really a nice play by Stabby.
And even when you know it's coming, Ohio State knows it. Stabby's going to throw the ball to Abradaris on third down. He still is able to make a play, but the left tackle, Meritz, locks up with Noah Spence. Noah Spence uses his speed to get around the corner. And you can see the left tackle. He tries to get out there, but he can't quite get out there quick enough. He has to lock up. He hooks it. Referee calls a holding call.
Yeah, good call. Yeah. Third down and 21. Stepping away and still looking. Now he's got to take off. Certainly not going to get the first down. But he didn't make the big mistake down there either. Joshua Perry, the linebacker, working defensively for the Buckeyes.
Ohio State just rushing three and dropping eight. They had three very, very deep on third and long and five underneath. Nowhere to go with the football for Stabby, so he just picks up as many yards as he can.
Talking to Kurt Phillips, fifth-year senior, who backs up Stabby. Bounce, and there's a penalty flag on this punt. Loose ball. Badgers have got it. But remember, there is a penalty flag. Badgers pounced on the loose ball. But now the key decision.
Illegal formation.
Chris Borland, who was lined out as a wing, was actually back in the backfield. 5 men in the backfield. You have the punter, the three personal protectors, and then Borland, who's out way to the right, lined up just a bit too far off the line of scrimmage.
A very costly mistake, because it didn't influence what happened at the other end at all.
No, not at all. And a few mistakes here for the Badgers with a missed field goal where they had the ball deep in Ohio State's territory. And now the blunder there on the punt.
Now Meyer backed up. Corey Brown awaits this punt. Catches it. Crosses midfield. And he's down at the 46-yard line. Jaguars 14, Badgers 7. You're watching ESPN Saturday Night Football on ABC. It's 14-7 Ohio State. Herbie, you got my Affleck card?
I certainly do. After 8 years, I figured.
Wait a minute. I read these.
No, but you're in Columbus. 8 years. I gotta be able to ask one question. And the Affleck trivia question. Name three.
Archie Griffin.
Number 45s in Buckeye history.
George, Google it quickly over there. Can you imagine that? 7:17 left, and here comes Braxton Dent. And down to the 43-yard line. Couldn't find anybody, eh, Herbie?
Well, he got pressure that time. Give Wisconsin some credit. He had some people downfield. The freshman, Dontre Wilson, actually was matched up one-on-one with Borland and got by him. But they had pressure. Tyler Dipple, a backup defensive end, beating his man over the top of him one-on-one and got the pressure. Made Braxton have to get out of the pocket.
Here's Carlos Hyde. Second down and five. First down, and they do. Corey Brown dances for it.
When this offense is clicking and they have the running game going with Hyde, they can throw the ball downfield, and then they get it out real quick. And the reason that ball is thrown, that's an alert by Braxton Miller. Armstrong was cheating a little bit too close to the line of scrimmage in the box. And because of that, Braxton Miller just aborted the fake, got the ball out. That's the next level where Braxton Miller in this offense has been able to get in this second year in the system.
Play action. Braxton with plenty of time. Now he's going to take off. And he's thrown down for a loss that time. And Warren Herring, the redshirt junior from Illinois, was on.
Well, Ohio State tries to go down again with the wheel route and give Ethan Armstrong, the outside linebacker, some credit here. He's locked up with Philly Brown, but he doesn't fall for a little short route, a little hesitation move, and then he's able to kind of catch up with him. They had two defenders there. Braxton Miller for a second time in a row now. No one to go to downfield. And Wisconsin's making some adjustments, not only on offense, but also with their defense and how they're trying to slow down Braxton Miller and the Buckeyes' attack.
Four wide receivers on this second and 12 for the Buckeyes. Looks back to the boundary, and short of the first down is Corey Brown.
That is a tight window, and Miller did everything he could to try to look the safeties off. It's not so much Hillary, but you're going into the teeth of this defense where the linebackers like to hit you and let you know about it. Good job of focusing on the football and giving them a chance here on third down and short.
Hyde has rushed for 57 yards and 7 carries. He's at the pistol behind Miller. Play action to him. Going to throw down the middle. Incomplete. Hillary with outstanding coverage that time. And not fooled on the play action. So give number 5 credit.
Give number 5 credit. He held up all by himself. The safety that time. McBoy comes up. And because of that, the crowd saying it was maybe a little bit of a pass interference. But I think Hillary out there by himself. Ball's up high. Because he's able to spot the football, they both have a chance. Equal chance to fight for the ball and fight with each other.
From the right hash, field goal unit is out on the field. Drew Basil.
All right. Your time is up, my friend, for your
okay.
Affleck.
Who were the three?
No. You called.
Duck, what are you doing?
You called.
You know what? I'm going out and eat duck after this game is over. I'm telling you right now, you're a dead duck.
How could you? You know Archie.
I said Archie Griffin. Who's that third one? That's your father.
That's my dad.
That's your dad, Jim.
1957-60.
Huh? Hey, Pops, I hope you're watching. Look at this. And later coached with Woody Hayes.
That's right.
That's Andy Ketzer. He hated my nickname. The big
cat. He didn't like that.
No. Is this Pops?
Yeah.
Show me this, Herbie.
There. This was on this summer. I saw this on the Big Ten Network. This is against the Indiana Hoosiers right here. Here's the crazy thing. Right here in Ohio Stadium. And yeah, he was a captain in 1960 with Jim Pyre.
Wow, Jim Tyrer, good line.
How about that?
Oh, yes.
Tom Matty back on those teams, too?
Good question, Herbie.
You like that?
And that's the last time you'll ask. 45 yards now. Here's your field goal. Brought it in beautifully at the end. 17-7 on the Drew Basil field goal.
Pools.
Welcome back to Columbus. Buckeyes lead by 10. Let's take a look at our Pacific Life game summary.
Talked about the importance of Wisconsin's passing game. Stavi's been able to do that. And eventually, you would think if you're a Wisconsin fan, it can open up Melvin Gordon and James. That's something they'll look to do in the second half. And who knows, maybe before this half is up. And for Ohio State, it's been about some big plays early in the game with Braxton Miller throwing the ball downfield and coming up with a couple touchdowns. But both teams kind of settling in and adjusting, especially with the defenses getting dialed in from the Badgers and trying to slow down Braxton Miller.
Line Zuleger out to the 23. I'll remind you that NFL Sunday coming up tomorrow, 10 a.m. Eastern. It's Sunday NFL Countdown. Chris Berman of the game provide all the latest news, updates from stadiums around the league. They'll have a conversation with Buccaneers quarterback Josh Freeman, who lost his job this week. He'll talk about his relationship with coach Greg Schiano. And then 11 a.m. on ESPN2, catch fantasy football. Get your team ready for the weekend. James White and Melvin Gordon on the field. Here's the fly sweep look. Stabby back. Fires complete. And that's Sam Arneson, the tight end.
Good protection. You mentioned a jet sweep. Watch how much they're alert to Gordon coming in motion. Watch how it affects the coverage from Ohio State and how they have to respect that. You see how they're locked in out here? They're worried about him, and it opens up a big void. And he's able to locate that. He used his eyes that time, in fact, to try to move the outside linebacker, Shazier. He moved him outside and then threw the ball to the tight end.
First down, and there's Gordon, right straight ahead for about 3-4 yards on that carry. That'll bring up second down. All the great running backs that they've had, and look at who was the fastest to 1,000 yards.
Look at that list of running backs. People call Penn State linebacker U, and there's different schools that are known for certain positions. Wisconsin, not just offensive linemen, some great running backs, especially over the last 20 or 25 years.
Stabby short drop on second down. Scott Aberderis, can he get the first down? He does. Into Ohio State territory.
And we saw Braxton Miller abort a handoff and get the ball out quickly to receiver. This time it's Stavi who sees Roby off late in the first half. Soft coverage. They're running a running play. He just comes out and gets the ball as quickly as he can out to his main receiver, and they pick up that first down.
Now the Wisconsin coaching staff is trying to bring this clock down on this drive. Yes, they want to score before the intermission, but they would like to do it near the end of the first half. Play action. Stavi rolls. Got a man open. Aberderis goes up in the air for another catch. Here are the best hands in the Big Ten, folks, right there.
They continue to go with their two tight end look. It puts Bradley Roby out there by himself. The double move out and up. Roby has his eyes in the backfield. He gets lost. Amazing adjustment by Aberderis. He was beat. Ball's underthrown. This is why he's one of the best. Outstanding acrobatic catch by Aberderis.
And working against a fine defensive back for 33 yards. Aberderis has 159 yards and 6 catches tonight. Now they pound. That's Gordon, the ball carrier, back to the line of scrimmage. Washington with the stop for the Buckeye. Back to that catch.
Yeah, it's worth another look. If he throws it downfield, it's a touchdown. But Aberderis, this is what great receivers do. Locate the football, and then not only does he go up and adjust and high point the ball, but the concentration to be able to hold on to it. And yeah, that's a first down.
He's going to get a look by an NFL team as a slot receiver.
He better.
Yeah, he's got that ability. James White. Stavi gets great protection. Incomplete. Abadaris double covered that time. Roby had help. Barnett was over there with him, the safety, and they doubled up number four.
This is going to be an interesting matchup. He's closest there in the slot to the ball. And again, Roby's getting away with some tugging. And all night, he's been using his hands, trying to stay close. He grabs onto the jersey there, gets away with it. Tell you, that's going to be the matchup in the second half. We knew early going in that was a matchup, but how's Ohio State adjust to stopping four and White from trying to give Wisconsin's offense balance? They've done a great job being able to exploit that.
Down to a minute and a half now. Third down and 11. End zone. Touchdown. Beautiful grab by Sam Arneson, the junior tight end. And what a big moment for the Badgers here at the end of the first half.
Seven plays, 76 yards, a little over 3 minutes. They're thinking about, well, can they get into field goal range? They're attacking tonight. They get the touchdown. Great concentration there by Arneson. Goes up and makes it. And that time, they spread Ohio State's defense out. Instead of that two tight end look, they spread them out, and they attacked back to the middle of the Buckeye defense.
The game plan is becoming completely clear. Y'all thought we came to run. Stavi's thrown for 210 yards tonight against that Buckeye secondary. Tack on the extra point, and it's a three-point game.
We knew coming in they were going to have to throw, but I don't know if anybody, including their own coaches, knew that they'd have this much success. What a great catch by Arneson. And again, look how they spread them out with all these wide receivers. And here is the tight end against two safeties in the middle of the field. He is able to spread the Ohio State defense out. The linebacker, Shazier, that time it wasn't Shazier, it was Joshua Perry. Didn't run at all, didn't even slow him down. So Stavi's in rhythm, puts the ball out. And what two great catches on this drive by Wisconsin. The first one by Abradaris, and that time by Arneson for the touchdown to hold on to that football after he was hit by Bryant.
And a half left in the first half. And coming up, stay tuned for the Capital One Halftime Report. We'll have scores and highlights from around a busy day of college football. Can Alabama pitch a shutout at Ole Miss? 6 minutes to go. They lead 60-0. John and Jesse will update you on that story. You'll hear about the big Clemson offense here today. Fielded at the 8-yard line by Hall. Bit of an alley over there out to about the 28-yard line. And Dandy on Monday night, folks. You're going to want to watch this one. Yes, indeed. Ryan Tannehill and the Dolphins are undefeated, folks. No surprise with Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. But I went to see the Dolphins.
Yeah.
And, of course, Brian Hartline is their key receiver. With Wallace stretching the field now, what a pickup he was from the Steelers. Hartline, we talk about a fellow with a good set of hands, right?
Yeah.
You're looking at one right there.
A lot like Abradaris,
yes,
in college.
Is.
That style of wide receiver, just signed an extension, long-term deal. He is a go-to guy for Tannehill.
Carlos Hyde. Braxton Miller keeping it. The run was his best run of the night. Put it on the ground, Borland, but they're going to whistle that one down after a gain of about 14 yards.
And with two timeouts, in a minute 17, this is a design draw, trying to get a first down. The clock will stop. And he's down clearly before the ball came out.
Quick snap to Braxton, fires back over the middle, and that is complete and short of the first down. Carlos Hyde, a receiver that time, out of the backfield, and time coming down now, inside of a minute, second down and six. Incomplete. It's third down and six. Corey Brown, the intended target. Southward, the safety, had coverage for the Badgers.
Yeah, Badgers are trying to make Braxton Miller prove that he can read coverage. It's one thing to throw against man-to-man and throw it downfield, but when they rush three and drop eight, you've got to read a lot of white jerseys. That time he made a great read on the flat defender who was up in coverage, put the ball where it had to be, but Philly Brown unable to hold on to it.
Clock starts. Miller breaks for the first down. With the Badger 43-yard line. Clock stops now while they move the chains.
They still have the two timeouts. Braxton Miller showing that left knee looks like it has recovered. First time we've seen him all night really running with purpose.
Looking down the far sideline, going deep, got one-on-one, and incomplete, and again, great coverage that time, and that is Shelton. Wow, what an upside this freshman has.
He got beat early by Devin Smith, and he's come back. He's giving the receiver this time enough of a cushion to give himself a chance. And that's actually Spencer trying to get vertical. Watch Shelton try to time this up. Spencer does everything he can to just keep Shelton away from that. But we've seen him now getting back there on those deeper throws and not getting beat deep.
Shelton, of course, with his eye on the football. That green line, by the way, is where they would have to get to attempt a long football by Basil. That would be the spot for his career. So here is Braxton, and there's a penalty flag.
Evan Spencer, some confusion about Ohio State. Evan Spencer ran onto the field
number six
from the sideline.
5 yard penalty
at the last second, actually crossed right in front of the referee and was trying to get lined up. And Braxton Miller snapped the ball.
Former Badger coach Brett Bielema trails Texas A&M 38-33 in the third quarter, late in the third quarter in that one. And Bielema in a shootout with Johnny Manziel.
Seems like Texas A&M is going to be in a lot of those kind of games this year with Johnny Manziel on offense and their defense a work in progress.
Florida's leading Kentucky 24-7. That game is in the fourth quarter. John and Jesse, of course, have all the highlights and stories from games earlier in the day, including Oklahoma and Notre Dame. Second down and 15. Braxton Miller being chased. Dances back with a great running ability. And he is short of that career-long spot.
And Ohio State will use one of their two timeouts. But Wisconsin, not only good coverage downfield, but their number one goal as a defense was preventing Braxton Miller from improvising. Look how they're getting. They're winning the point of attack. Chris Borland is a middle linebacker, and at 5'11", 246 pounds, he's getting as much pressure as anybody on Braxton Miller. Look at that spin move. He gets around Carlos Hyde, forces Miller to run, but he doesn't give up on the play. And you got a lot of white jerseys trying to keep him contained and not let him hit that big play.
So earlier in the week, some of the Mississippi players said, we can score on those fellas down in Tuscaloosa. How's that working out, Herbie, here late in the fourth quarter?
Goose egg?
Goose egg.
They've had some chances, but you got to execute. You got to put it into the end zone. They've been inside Alabama territory two or three times and come away with 0 points. By the way, remember you said, does the SEC play defense? We know one team that really does. In Florida, without Dominique Easley, they're showing it. They're still playing some defense.
Third down and 7. Now Braxton looking long downfield, a little underthrew it and almost intercepted. Shelton couldn't hang on. He had a shot at a pick that time and couldn't hang on.
We're seeing a true freshman growing up before our eyes tonight. Folks in Madison have to be pretty excited about how this true freshman is held up. We saw him on the other side of the field against Evan Spencer. This time, he's not able to come up with the interception. But the point is, the ball is underthrown. It's poorly thrown. And Shelton is at least in position to be able to make a play on it again.
And on fourth down, Braxton Miller. Far side got a man open. Touchdown, Buckeyes. Corey Brown. The final play of the first half. and Corey Brown catches a 40-yard touchdown pass thrown by Brexton Miller. Now take a look at the replay.
Look, this is a rope. He didn't loft this up. He put that on a line to give Corey Brown a chance to be able to catch his football. If he floats that or puts a little bit of a touch on it, the defender's able to come over there. A mental lapse by Wisconsin on this last play here, and a big play for Braxton Miller at Ohio State.
It was fourth and seven, and Corey Brown, young man who loves to play football, the coaches told us, his nickname, Philly.
That's right. Philly Brown just goes right through the middle of the defense. You have a corner on the outside and a safety. Look at the corner right here, and here's the safety. He's going to split them in half. And when he gets through there, that's a mental mistake. The safety is late over the football in the middle of the field. Braxton Miller recognizes it, and look at the arm strength here. Tight spiral. Ball is low to be able to, again, get it in there as quickly as he can. Threw that ball in a hurry.
So Braxton Miller throws three touchdown passes in the first half. And Stabby throws two for the Badgers. We've had five touchdown passes here in the first half of this football game.
Just a breakdown in coverage by the Wisconsin free safety, and Philly Brown in position to make that big play.
Can't wait to see what's going to happen in the second half of this one. Buckeyes enjoying a 10-point lead at the intermission behind the return of quarterback Braxton Miller. Abraderis and the rest of the Badgers will regroup and battle back, and let's check in now with Heather Cox and Coach Anderson.
Brent, thanks so much. Coach, how did that 40-yard touchdown pass by the Buckeyes change your approach as you head into the locker room?
Missed opportunities. That's not just the only one. You know, two long passes, missed field goal. You're not going to win these games if you don't take care of the ball. We're doing some good things on offense, but the bottom line is we got to produce at crunch time and make big plays. It's inexcusable.
You talk about your offense. Badgers third in the nation in rushing, but tonight it's your passing game that shines. What kind of offensive balance do you need to see in the second half?
Well, I think a little bit of both. We're going to continue down those roads. If they're going to play the box that heavy, then we'll hit with some play-action passes. And the key is when we get in the red zone, we got to score touchdowns. We can't miss field goals. We knew we have to score some points walking in here. That hasn't changed, but we can't give up freebies.
Gary, we appreciate it. Thank you. Brent?
You know, Brent, he talked about missed opportunities. Shelton dropped that interception right before the touchdown. It's another one.
Honest man. I like that, Coach. Into the first half. Stay tuned after these messages with the Capital One Halftime Report. Night Football presented by Windows.
Kick shoes off, let your head out. Pull your beard out, just beard out.
We are back, and Ohio State will receive the second half kickoff. They lead Wisconsin 24-14 by 10 here. And, Kirby, you know, one of the things that Braxton Miller has always been capable of making big plays. Those close games last year, and at the end of the first half, nothing bigger than that touchdown.
Yeah, he kept some plays alive, but nothing bigger than that last play there before the first half ended. And, you know, the Wisconsin corner right here, he gets lost. Gene gets confused. It's fourth down. But Fields going to the outside, catches his eye just long enough to allow Philly Brown to go by him. See, he's responsible for the deep third, which means nothing gets behind you, let alone last play on fourth down in the first half. There was no, absolutely no way that Southward could come over and make that play. It was actually the corner, Gene, who bit on the under route instead of worrying about Philly Brown going by him. That was costly to end that first half.
It'll be interesting to see how the Badgers respond. Will they be able to get that running game finally going? They rushed for only 50 yards in the first half. But first things first, It is Buckeye football. Start the second half. We take a look at our Pacific Life game summary and let us compare the two quarterbacks. Five touchdown passes total.
Yeah, we knew coming in that Stavi would have to throw the football to be able to open up the running game, and they made that adjustment after their first series, and it has opened up their play-action passing game. Look for that to continue. See how Ohio State tries to stop Aberderis. And boy, Braxton Miller, three touchdown passes. And he, of course, trying to get the ball behind man-to-man coverage and make some big plays in the passing game.
Carlos Hyde carried the ball seven times for 57 yards. Quick flip to the outside and Corey Brown, and they pick up about 6 yards as we check in down below with Heather.
Urban Meyer's big concern coming into this game was defending Wisconsin's fly series against White and Gordon. He told me at halftime, we've done that. We've done that very well. The problem, we have not defended the passing game well. We've got to put a lot more pressure on the quarterback. And then he said it comes down to fundamentals. We must tackle better in the second half if we want to win.
And he would like to establish a little daylight with a scoring drive here on the opening series of the second half. And again, he'll go back to Brown. They're soft, and they pick up a first down. Pretty easy picking as soon as Braxton Miller spots the corner off that far.
Yeah, he has free rein there to be able to pull that trigger and get the ball out on the perimeter as quickly as he can. And not only did he pick up a first down there, this is all part of attacking horizontally, getting the ball outside, making those linebackers be aware of that. Then you can go back to running the football with Carlos Hyde and trying to attack into the inside of the Wisconsin defense.
And here is Carlos sliding off that left side. Jack Muhort over there, the left tackle, 6'6 out of Toledo, Ohio, a senior. Andrew Norwell, he's 6'6 from Cincinnati's Anderson High School. Corey Lindsley's healthy tonight. He's your Buckeye center. Marcus Hall and Taylor Decker over on the right side.
The style of offense puts a lot on the Wisconsin linebackers and safeties and test their eye discipline to try to locate their reads and find the football.
An upside look, and Braxton's going to try to get the first down and cannot. Third and short coming up here for the Bucs.
Wisconsin, one area that they feel very, very good about this year, not just this game, is their front seven. A lot of experience up front with Allen, Hemier, Muldoon, of course, Chris Borland anchoring those linebackers. They've been active tonight.
And Braxton uses Hyde to hammer for the first down.
Big block by Norwell leading his way, leading his back that time around the right side. The left guard just pulling around on a power play. And again, Carlos Hyde has the power himself to be able to run through on those short yardage situations. Ohio State, again, kind of nickel and diming here early. Don't be surprised with Tom Herman and Urban Meyer. That's when they try to attack downfield.
Braxton going to keep it. Runs in to his own man, Hyde, the running back, and goes down on the play. And Muldoon blew that thing up, and Carlos was on the ground, and he tripped over. Braxton, of course, rushed for over 1,200 yards last year. That's right, over 1,200. He rushed for 13 touchdowns for the Buckeyes, and that's why he was the Big Ten Player of the Year and finished fifth in the Heisman as this team went 12-0. Urban Meyer, of course, 16-0. As the Buckeye head coach, he inherited a 6-7 Buckeye team. So he's done a really solid job here. Braxton rushes again for another first down. They'll move the chains. They're now in Badger territory, and they're starting to hammer away.
And now we're starting to see Braxton Miller run the football. Remember, he's coming off the sprained MCL where he's missed a couple games. There's a lot of talk. Would he be in this week? Does he deserve to be in this week? I think they eased him in the first half as far as their play selection. He ran when he had to run. He ran towards the end of the first half to keep some plays alive. He's come out here to start this second half. There's some design runs and some options to get the ball in his hands and let him use his feet.
Andre Wilson has stepped up alongside the quarterback, so he's in as the running back. Play fake to him. Deep down field, diving in. Oh, yes, he grabbed it, I believe. Instant replay will have to justify what I saw. It is being marked down at about the 1 yard line. Here it comes.
Let's see if it hit the surface.
It did.
It sure did. Great
yes,
focus
indeed.
There by Evan Spencer.
Exciting for a time until yeah. The fellows upstairs.
Tremendous.
Take a look at it.
Boy, he's extended himself. Ball goes in the air. Never loses his focus.
The crowd's trying to influence instant replay. Sorry, but the window's closed. They're showing these plays like this more and more in the stadium to give the fans the experience that they would have at home. Why not show them the plays that Instant Replay's looking at? Very good idea. We see it all across the Big Ten stadiums this year.
This is the best look, and it shows the football hitting the turf. Pops up off the ground, but great effort by Spencer. His dad, of course, coached Tim Spencer, played at Ohio State, coached in the NFL for a long time with the Chicago Bears. And Evan's thinking about the NFL. He caught that. Even though he was down, he's trying to wiggle into the end zone, but this one will come back.
Dan Capron, our referee, Jim Shaw, umpire. Urban's bringing the gang over. I'm sure the coaches upstairs have told him what we've seen.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Incomplete pass, second down.
Oh, I really thought the one official called it complete. So I apologize for that when I looked down there. But it's, I mean, it is a very good call. Yeah, that was not a completed pass.
You go back to
second down and 10.
Yeah, and sometimes with those replays, you forget what was the down and distance. It was first and 10. They took a shot downfield. Brings up a second and 10. They bring in the speedster, the true freshman, Dontre Wilson. Lined up off to the left to Braxton Miller.
Well, they had him in on that last running play, and now they got the two of them together and motion Wilson out of there. And Braxton's going to take off. And he's punished at about the 40-yard line there. And Chris Borland, number 44, was in on the quarterback.
It's so tough when you have a spread attack with a quarterback that can run and throw. Braxton Miller has tailback ability in running the football, so it becomes a numbers game. And when you have a young freshman like Dontre Wilson who can electrify the crowd and make big plays, you have to respect that. And then they go back to Braxton Miller trying to take advantage of numbers in the box and run, but Wisconsin holding firm up front.
Borland moves up to the line of scrimmage on the left side. Braxton back to throw for it on third down. Going to come deep in zone. Incomplete. Devin Smith, who has one of the three touchdown passes, was the target. Shelton, that good-looking freshman, was right there.
Again, these corners are being asked to hold up on islands. And, boy, it's off the fingertips. The ball is thrown right there. And I don't know if he got his head around late there and couldn't find the football until the last moment, but Devin Smith usually makes that catch. That's a touchdown that he dropped.
Agony of being a fan. Huh? Fourth down now. Aberderis is back deep. Cameron Johnston punts it away. Aberderis going to let this one go. And it's going to roll down at the 6-yard line. Tough field position for Stabby and the Badgers, but that's where they'll be when you come back. You're watching ESPN Saturday Night Football on ABC.
Oh no, here we go again. Oh dear. I need a little help here. I'm sorry, I don't have a USB port. Oh snap. You have a real keyboard too? This isn't going to end well for me, is it? Nope.
Coach's Trophy, presented by Dr. Pepper, will be awarded to the winner of the Vizio BCS National Championship on January 6th at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. So the championship game will be played in the Rose Bowl Stadium. And of course, the Rose Bowl itself, and SEC will be hoping to extend that string of championships. Melvin Gordon in as the running back behind the fullback. They're going to see if they can get it going as he breaks out. picks up a couple of yards.
Remember the first half adjustments for Wisconsin. It was the play action pass that really got them in sync and allowed Stavi to have a big first half. Ohio State is geared up to stop the running backs. So they're dinking and dunking and then taking some shots downfield. Sam Arneson here with a touchdown towards the end of the first half, but it's a passing game that has been setting up their running game and getting them into rhythm.
Fumble,
and there's a penalty flag.
False start, offense, number 79, half the distance to the goal, second down.
Now, this can be one of the noisiest stadiums in the country. Nothing is easy for a visiting team down here when they're trying to get the snap count going. And remember, young Dan Fultz has had to step in at center. Lou Allen is out with an injury, and it can be loud and louder here at the Horseshoe in Columbus. Second down and 11. Gordon runs up the backside of Wozniak, one of his tight ends.
And 10 men that time at the line of scrimmage, and Wisconsin played pretty well in the first half. And you heard the interview with Gary Anderson and Heather Cox when he's walking off the field. Look at these mistakes. And he said, hey, we're on the road in a big game like this. We can't have these kind of mistakes and expect to be able to get out of here with a victory. At the bottom of the screen.
On third and six, Stavi shakes away from one defender, shakes two, but then he's surrounded and short of the first down. Badgers forced to punt.
Boy, Michael Bennett, the junior out of Centerville, Ohio, with a great, great move on the inside. Just tremendous quickness. That time he went by Volts initially. The right guard, Costigan, didn't have much of a chance. Give Stavi a chance to be able to try to keep that play alive, but it was the quickness up front by Michael Bennett.
Drew Meyer punting from the Badger end zone, and Corey Brown standing at midfield for the Buckeyes. Buckeyes have had better field position all game long, and they certainly do here, working inside the 50-yard line. We'll be right back.
My dad always talks about the deal he and Mom made with me when I was 10. He said, you get the grades to go to college, and we'll help out with the school of your choice. Well, I got the grades, and with Dad's planning and a lot of hard work, I'm graduating today with a degree in marine biology. I'm so thankful and excited about the future.
For strategies on how to help your family achieve financial success, visit PacificLife.com.
So I can reach Ally Bank 24/7, but there are no branches?
24/7.
I'm sorry, I'm just really reluctant to try new things.
Really? What's wrong with trying new things?
Look, Mommy's new vacuum.
You feel that in your muscles?
Drink water. It's a long story.
Well, not having branches lets us give you great rates and service.
I'd like that.
A new way to bank, a better way to save. Ally Bank, your money needs an ally.
Like a child, this Cree LED bulb could be in your house for decades. Unlike a child, it'll pay for itself and spend its life saving you money. And it will never pierce its tongue.
The Cree LED bulb.
When it comes to doing what you love, more is better.
Saturday Night Football presented by Windows. Brought to you by Nissan, premier partner of the Heisman Trophy. The Cree LED bulb, the biggest thing since the light bulb. And Ally Bank, your money needs an ally.
The Easy Living Deli, one of the most popular eateries on the Ohio State campus, founded by former Buckeye kicker Vlade Yanikiewski. You saw him there with his lovely wife. He was named to the Buckeyes All-Century Team in 2000. outstanding field goal specialist. And when you go in to visit him, ask for the Vladdy special. You will not be disappointed. Here comes Carlos Hyde. He's been over for a couple of those sandwiches.
That's now, your first stop.
You gotta go see my man Vladdy.
You're going there for a sandwich.
Now, he prepared box lunches, not for just Ohio State after the game,
right,
but Wisconsin.
Yeah.
They're taking the box lunch out to the airplane. That's how good this is.
Wow.
And so one of the Buckeye fans, and they said, come on, Vladdy, you can't be making sandwiches for the Badgers. So listen, I can make a sandwich, but without the love.
Oh, man.
He's a wonderful character. You want to talk a little bit about Ohio State football, find out what's going on with the team, go over there and chat it up with Vladdy. So here comes Braxton Miller now. Picked up about 3 yards. Chris Borland is there. What an active linebacker.
Well, Herbie. Let's watch him here just flow with this defense. Gets through the all that traffic in the middle of the Ohio State offensive line. Boy, Ohio State's trying to get to the second level, but these Wisconsin linebackers, when the Buckeyes try to run the football, doing a good job of getting away from the linemen and flowing to the football.
Third and four, and Buckeyes are only 3 of 8 against Chris and his buddies on defense here tonight on third down. Need 4 here. Gonna get it on a run? No, he does not. And that was Caputo, Michael Caputo. Sophomore safety, redshirt sophomore out of Imperial, Pennsylvania.
Yeah,
and they made a good play.
They used him as a safety. They walked him up closer to the line of scrimmage for this game because of Braxton Miller. That time he spied Braxton Miller on third down and made the play.
Last fourth down, touchdown pass at the end of the half. Here they go. Here's Hyde. Stopped. There's Borland, number 44, pushing back in the middle. A big stop by the Badgers. Number 44. Folks, he's got instinct. I know he's not the physical specimen of an NFL linebacker. But does anybody plug more than
him? He's Mike Singletary, or he's an Ernie Mills. He's that kind of guy. Look how he's – and give credit to Wisconsin's defensive line. Tyler Dipple that time ate up the lineman in front of him. See him eat up that line. Another linebacker is able to – Connor O'Neill's picks up the pulling lineman, frees 44 to make the play.
Badger's turn when you come back.
Welcome aboard.
Now you'll know when to stop. The Nissan Altima, with easy fill tire alert.
Wisconsin takes over on downs because of number 44. 11 tackles tonight.
Yeah, 11 tackles, 7 solo. Makes that big stop on fourth down. Goes right over the sideline to talk to his team about, guys, we are still in this game. We can stop these guys.
Now it's the offense's turn. Trailing by 10. Play action stop. He's in trouble. Sack. Thrown for a loss by Curtis Grant.
Curtis Grant, they've been waiting for him to come on. He comes right through here on the blitz. Ohio State getting aggressive on first and 10. A little bit of a miscommunication, and Havenstein just wasn't able to get outside quick enough. I don't know if he didn't see him until the last second, but a miscue up front frees up Grant to make a big play, and the Buckeyes and Luke Fickell dialing up the blitz there on first and 10. That's their adjustment to that play action on first and 10 by the Badgers.
Now on second and 19, somebody better watch number 4. And it will be Roby. Looking in that direction, firing, intercepted, picked off near midfield by Roby. Roby had Aberderis, backed off, made the pick. Buckeyes are in business.
Scobie got pressure from Adalvis Washington out of Cincinnati. And I don't know if Stavi panicked, but there's a miscommunication off to the left. Look at Washington battling to get pressure. And I think he just threw and hoped. And there was nobody in, you know, Alex Erickson, the freshman receiver, is running with his back to him, but he feels, look at 92 closing in on him, Washington, and he just throws it. And Erickson never was even looking for the football. And an easy interception that time for the All-American corner, Roby.
Let's see now if Urban Meyer elects to go for the throat after the turnover. Instead, he will hand it off to the running back, Wilson, and he cuts back. Got a beautiful block. Crosses the 20 and out of bounds. Freelancing. the freshman from Texas, does it all on the cutback, and he picked up a couple of beautiful blocks.
And he didn't give up on this, but how about the block by Braxton Miller? He keeps the play alive. That's Borland chasing. Boom, right there. You think Braxton Miller's okay with that left knee? Pretty good teammate there to free up the freshman.
First and 10. Braxton now running it himself. Shakes away from Borland, but Borland slowed him up in time. And Tanner McAvoy, a one-time quarterback, cleans it up.
This goes over well in the film room, by the way. Showing an unselfish attitude, a quarterback who gets so much attention. Showing an ability to not only block, but a willingness to block, to pick up valuable yards in this game.
Second down and 10 for Miller and the Buckeyes. And here comes Hyde, and now it will be third down. For the play call, his quarterback coach Tom Herman upstairs. Now signal that play in. Notice now, watch how he claps to start the cadence. Now it's up to the center to call a snap count for the Buckeyes. Fire off to the right, complete, first down, first and goal. Fine effort by Devin Smith. What happens is Urban Meyer has always used the clap because he feels it from tackle to tackle. As we have an injured Badger down, you can hear it. But then it is up to the center to get his head up as you watch the replay here.
Yeah, the ball goes high on third down, and tremendous, tremendous catch, showing pretty good leaping ability by Devin Smith. But Brent, you're right. It's you're lying your center. You need a guy who's intelligent, can make the right call. They have that in Corey Linsley. And the ball that time is high, but a very, very good catch by Devin Smith.
Now the other side of it is your center has got to have a good voice. And they feel that Corey Linsley does, but he actually calls the count. But the reason why Urban went to this is so that the center can look at that Mike linebacker and not have his head down. Now here's Linsley. He will watch for the clap of the hands by the quarterback, and then he will bark it out. There's the snap to Braxton, rolling to the left, cut back. Can't get in. Did I see 44 over the top?
Yeah, if somebody's running with a football, you can see the instinctive linebacker somewhere in the middle of it. Here they go with a hurry up.
Hand off, Hyde. He is stood up in the hole by you know who. Oh, wow.
Again, Wisconsin's defensive line eats up all of the linemen, and they do that intentionally to free up Borland for that kind of hit right there. That's Carlos Hyde running at 235 pounds. You talk about pop. You talk about being explosive as a linebacker. That's Chris Borland.
Now it's third and goal for the Buckeyes. Hyde, no, Braxton kept it, threw it into the end zone for the touchdown. Beautiful play action. Corey Brown caught it. Corey Brown's second touchdown of the night. And four touchdown passes for Braxton Miller, but great play action on that play.
Yeah, I think that was a play that was improvised by Braxton Miller. There's so many different options in this offense, not just reading the zone read and handing it off or keeping it, but you're thinking about handing it off or keeping it, and then instead of pitching an option, it's a pass. Good thing they're on the same page there, because that was close to being a little bit dicey for Ohio State on third and goal.
So the interception led to the touchdown. As you take a look, the young man's second touchdown catch of the game. Aerial coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires that go the distance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Badgers up against it now, 31-14.
Touchdown and the different options that Braxton Miller has. Here's Philly Brown, but the read is right here, and what Braxton Miller has to make a determination is if the safety commits inside with southward, he's got to be able to make an adjustment and then give the ball to the outside. Wisconsin defended it well, but the safety came off of the receiver, and that's the main reason they ended up trying to squeeze it in there to Philly Brown. So if Southard would have stayed on Philly Brown, that play would have been blown up by Wisconsin.
So Gary Anderson's Badgers trailing 31-14. Melvin Gordon, the running back. Right up the middle for 8 yards. Gary left his son behind at Utah State. And he's a sort of an H-back fullback, Keegan Anderson. And last night for Utah State, here he is slipping out of the backfield. And there he's being hit by Chucky Keaton for an easy touchdown. Utah State pulls away from San Jose. And there is Pops right there, of course, very proud of what the young man is accomplishing back with the team that he left behind. They blast for the first down with that running attack. Let us blast ahead to Robert Flores. Robert.
All right, going to check out this Taco Bell Live Moss moment. Happened late in the game today between Georgia and LSU. Aaron Murray, Mary present. Justin Scott Wesley, go-ahead score. Georgia beating LSU 44-41. Murray with 5 total touchdowns.
Big, big day for the Dogs. First down and 10. Play action. Stoppy rolling hard to the left. Incomplete. And a penalty flag will come down. Aberderis, the intended receiver, and Roby perhaps a little too tight on him this time.
They've completed that pass off play action where he rolls out about a 15, 20 yard out off of the play action. And they've burnt Roby on that with Aberderis. This time he sits on the route and then tries to jump it, and he got there just a little bit prematurely.
You heard the crowd's reaction to the big replay screen here.
Pass interference. Defense, number one. Spot clock. Automatic first down.
Again, he's isolated out there. He's been out there all by himself all night. He just got a little bit too close too quickly. You see him hooking the arm there. I mean, the crowd doesn't get that vantage point, but you can see that he got not only there early, but he's been grabbing his jersey and grabbing onto his arm all night. That time they caught him for it.
First down and 10. Hand off. And that is White. Well, Monday Night Football, and it's a good one. It'll be Ryan Tannehill and the Miami Dolphins against Drew Brees and the New Orleans Saints. Battle of the unbeatens. And by the way, Herbie, can I make a request to Chris Berman of the gang for a story one of these weeks?
Yeah.
Somebody go down and tell me why the Jacksonville Jaguars haven't signed Tim Tebow. I know. Hang on. If you're going to give away free beer, if you sign a contract with Tebow, you'll fill that stadium down there. I'm telling you,
you're right.
Having me up back with the punt. I mean, what's wrong with that?
Just have him in the uni, huh?
Absolutely. First down, blasting ahead.
You were giving NFL tips last week.
Well, how'd that work out?
Exactly. You're giving more tips out, huh?
Giants. Well, listen.
Those Giants look good. Is that one thing your team you like?
Listen, I'm not going to make a big argument about Tim Tebow, but when you talk to Urban Meyer about his former star from Florida, he can't figure it out either. Because all the youngster has done is win an open. By the way, the last time he did play a lot of quarterback, the Denver Broncos went to the playoffs, eventually got blown out. I know he's got a little trouble with that long delivery of his. I get it. James White. But if I'm Jacksonville and I can't sell the stadium out, I'm signing Tebow. I'm sorry. Stavi back now. Gonna fire downfield, incomplete.
That's a miscommunication. They had some receivers open downfield. And that time, you could almost see Sam Arneson looking back and saying, hey, my bad. Stavi was throwing it in one spot. Arneson stopped in zone coverage in another. And they just missed on it. Ohio State stacking the line. And Wisconsin's had some success taking some shots downfield. They had an opportunity there. But again, the miscommunication by the quarterback and the big tight end.
Second down and 10. Melvin Gordon. Out to the right. Very good vision as we come to the end of the third quarter. Buckeyes dominated that quarter. They lead at 31-14, and there's an injured Badger down on the field right now. So we'll check
Melvin
that out.
Gordon.
And we'll be back after this message and a word from your local ABC station. Welcome back to ESPN Saturday Night Football, presented by Windows. 31-14 as we start the fourth quarter. Melvin Gordon up on that far side after he was shaken up here, Herbie.
Yeah, battling for as many yards as he can pick up. There's the initial contact from Grant. And he's just extending himself. And Perry comes in late there, and he's holding his left leg as he went to the sideline. But he did walk off, which is great news.
Third down and 5, so James White is the running back behind Stavi. Trying to sweep left, and he has slowed down Washington, and there's a flag on the play.
Yeah, that Wisconsin moved.
False start. Offense, number 49. 5-yard penalty, third down.
That's Arneson moving, and let's check in with Heather.
Well, the Wisconsin training staff and head athletic trainer Mike Mull continue to evaluate Melvin Gordon's lower left leg. They had him on the bench, talked to him quite a bit. Now he's up testing it, putting weight on that left leg, seeing if he can go. I've been told they're still evaluating and haven't made a decision about his future in this game. Also, guys, wide receiver Jordan Frederick right now is questionable as well. So the Badger offense struggling.
Third and 10 for that offense. Can he get the first down? Cannot. But you might as well go for it here.
Yeah, they're going to have to go for it. Down 17 into the fourth quarter. Good field position deep in Ohio State territory. Pretty big play here. Duckworth gets underneath coverage. Almost picked up the first down before Perry brought him down. Ohio State was taking everything away deep. Stavi had to throw it underneath.
Derek Watt will be the fullback. White is behind him on fourth and 2. Here's White. Let's see where it's spotted. Line judge coming from this direction indicates that he might have picked it up. Officials timeout. They bring the chains out.
Ohio State defensive line going up against probably the most physical offensive line they'll face all year. You know, they lost 6 of their starting 7 in their front 7. Ryan Shazier, the only one that returned this year.
Big first down when you're trailing by 3 scores early in the fourth quarter.
Yeah, they had to roll the dice there and take a chance. There's a pretty good push there. Ohio State knew that it was going to be to the right or to the left with James White. But now you go back to the play-action game. Aberderis will be up at the top of the screen. They've not had any luck at all in the second half of getting him the football. Let's see if they can now after they pick up the first down.
Roby is one-on-one. And he tightens up on it. Stavi looks back in that direction. Penalty flag is down. Aberderis. It's an incomplete pass on the field, but there is a penalty flag thrown in the defensive backfield.
They may have got him again for holding. I said earlier, Roby on these double moves has been locking on to Abradaris, grabbing arms, grabbing his
holding.
Jersey.
Defense, number one.
Yeah, got him again.
10-yard penalty, automatic first down.
The double move that he's setting him up with, and he's holding on to his jersey when he tries to get separation. That ball, if it's thrown on time and higher, that's a touchdown.
Badgers move to the 17-yard line with this first down.
In that same spot, and they leave Roby isolated, doesn't have a safety behind him.
White bounces outside. Touchdown, Badgers. Good vision.
And great vision and a great block by the fullback, Derek Watt. The corner lost contained. Duran Grant right there, 12. Keep an eye on him. 34 Watts going to take him out of the play. Poor angle by Christian Bryant and a huge running lane to the outside for James White. But Grant, the corner's got to hold firm there and try to force that ball back to the inside where the rest of his defense is.
17-yard touchdown. Badgers down by two scores. Lots of time left here in the fourth quarter. The senior from South Florida. And the Badgers are in business. Area coverage provided by Goodyear. Everything Goodyear has learned making tires that go the distance inspires what they roll into yours. Goodyear, more driven. Beautiful night here in Columbus, Ohio. Over 100,000 fans have packed the horseshoe. Their beloved Buckeyes up by 10, 31-21. The Badgers hanging tough with their last touchdown. Big fourth down play for them. Bouncing kickoff fielded on the 15-yard line by Wilson. And Wilson with that breakaway, 30. Out of bounds at about the 37-yard line as we take a look at our Pacific Life game summary. Buckeye defensive front done a pretty good job.
They have. They're doing a good job of fighting off blocks. There hadn't been a lot of running room for Melvin Gordon and James White, and it's made Wisconsin attack in different areas. And Ohio State, when they've had the ball, Braxton Miller, especially early in the game, making some big plays. This is the biggest one before the half, where he hit Philly Brown for a touchdown, put Ohio State up by 10. And we are, as you said, Brent, this game's far from being over at 10 points. We'll see if Ohio State continues to be aggressive or tries to work clock here.
Braxton going to keep it on a design play behind high. Good 14-yard gain on that first down run. And the freshman pulling away saying, I didn't hit him back out of bounds.
Braxton Miller actually did a smart thing, a veteran move. He grabbed the head of the freshman and tried to pull him into him once he got out of bounds, almost trying to get the call. That's a veteran crafty move there by Miller.
First down and 10. Gain on that play.
Muldoon with some penetration. Veteran defensive line of Bo Allen, Ethan Hamer, and Pat Muldoon. They've adjusted to a 3-4 this year. Gary Anderson coming in. Four linebackers, three defensive linemen. It's an active bunch, led, of course, by Chris Borland.
Second down and 10. Borland was trying to get there and could not. Receiver spun away and picked up about 4 yards, and that was Jeff Hierman for 86.
I think Ohio State, the growth is not just with Braxton Miller. Think about this offense a year ago in the first year with Tom Herman here as the offensive coordinator, and Braxton and Urban Meyer. It was really Braxton Miller running and Carlos Hyde running and occasionally taking a deep shot. So much more versatile now with tight ends and the young freshman Wilson. The receivers as a group have improved. They can attack in a lot of different areas.
Third and seven, good protection. Fires for the first down to Devin Smith.
I understand giving the speed of Devin Smith a cushion, but how many times do you and I see this? It's college football, third down, and you're giving them an 8 to 10 yard cushion, and then you're bailing. On first and 10, where Ohio State might take a shot, that makes sense, but Shelton might want to consider tightening up the coverage, especially late in the game when you're down 10. And you get him to third down, you can't make it that easy for Braxton Miller and his receiver.
Carlos Hyde leads Braxton Miller again. And the Buckeyes working on that clock right now as we check in with Robert Flores.
Hey, Brent, over on ESPN, Stanford taking control over Washington State in Seattle. Kevin Hogan to Devin Kahoust. That combination has worked a couple of times, and the Cardinal rolling 17-3 early second quarter.
Interesting now, because the voters in the various polls that are used, and this is the final year of the BCS, you got a lot of teams jockeying for the number two spot behind Alabama. Oregon, of course, Ohio State right here, Clemson, Stanford's in that mix. Hyde is stopped. So it is important not just that you win the game.
So true.
When you're looking at that number two, how you win the game, and did you impress the coaches around the country and the members of the Harris Poll and things like that.
And especially when you play in certain conferences where you're not going to get necessarily those impact moments in big-time opponents. You know, think about a Louisville in the AAC. I mean, every time they take the field, not only is that about winning, they've got to try to look as good as they can.
Inside of 10 minutes now on this third and four snap.
Empty usually means Braxton Miller on third down tries to run here for Ohio State.
And he slips and he's down.
That's
at the 35-yard line.
A big stop
for
for
the Badgers, and pressure was coming from Warren Herring.
Warren Herring, he was a backup on the interior 45 right in the middle. Watch him go right around the veteran center, Lensley. Great quickness, and again, they've done a wonderful job of rotating different defensive linemen. They have two deep across the board. They've been able to stay fresh, and against Ohio State's tempo, you see a backup nose guard like this coming in and applying some pressure. Great depth up front. And I think, I know Urban Meyer likes to go for it, but that took him out of field goal range. That's sad.
The ball is on the 35-yard line. It is fourth down and 11. He's talking to his
fourth down.
Yeah. And now he's talking to some of the specialists down there. Now remember, if they punt it, they'd love to pooch this and try to get it down inside the 10-yard line if this is what he wants to do right here. He's got the punt team on the field now. He does not want to give the Badgers this field position, but he wants to bury him on this if they can. The Badgers very alert. Abradaris is back deep. Just pooches it. Fair catch. And at about the 8-yard line.
Oh, no.
Saturday Night Football presented by Windows. Brought to you by Windows. Liberty Mutual Insurance. Responsibility. What's your policy? And Taco Bell. Sometimes you gotta live Moss.
The godfather of Ohio State football. Woody Hayes. Athletic Center named for him. Look down from the blimp live. The practice facility, which has been expanded. Coach's office, you swing over to the softball, the baseball, soccer stadiums here. Now the Badgers have been lethal with long drives tonight. 90, 76, 75. They'll try to mount, still another one. White, the running back. That was for about a yard, and he is thrown back by Shazier. And of course, a reminder, NASCAR's best continue to drive for the championship. Matt Kenseth, 2 for 2 in the chase for the Sprint Cup. He's lengthened his points lead. Don't miss the Sprint Cup series at Dover tomorrow, 1 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
You know, we have not seen Melvin Gordon back in the lineup since he went out, where he tweaked his left leg. James White has been carrying the bulk of the load when they run the football. But again, just to remind folks, most of the success when they've moved the ball has been through the air.
They'll go to the air right now, and Aberderis makes it third and short, and we go down below. Aberderis is now shaken up. With Gordon on the sideline, now Aberderis slow getting up. Let's check in down below now with Heather.
Yeah, Brent, this Badger offense really struggling. Gary Anderson, in fact, just held them all together and said, seize the opportunity. We've got another one. But Jordan Frederick, their wide receiver, I've confirmed, is out for the game with what they're calling a head injury. Melvin Gordon has ice on that left knee. He is very doubtful to return. And I'll keep my eye on Aberderis for you guys.
He just checked out of the lineup here on a big third down.
Third down and two. White was a little bit slow on getting to the mesh point, I thought. Had a fullback who took off. It was almost like you wanted a long handoff on that play. And he's a little bit short right there. You know what? They got to go, I would think, down a couple of scores. Let's see what Gary decides. He's still got 7-11, which is a lot of time. He's got his punter on the field right now.
Urban Meyer stepped out of the field and just kind of waving his hands like a safe sign, meaning don't rush him. Do not rush him and rough him.
Corey Brown takes a Badger bounce. Yeah, I guess it would have, had they failed, they would have given the
game
Buckeyes
over.
Just a gimme field position down there. And Gary trying to play a percentage, punts it away, but time is against the Badgers. Becker Columbus, we want to remind you about Sunday NFL Countdown presented by IBM, Sunday at 10 a.m. Of course, the NFL goes over to London. Pittsburgh will be playing in that game against Minnesota. A lot of chatter this week about putting an expansion team in London. I got a better idea. Let's put one in Los Angeles. And who should start for your fantasy team? Well, you can check that out tomorrow, too, tomorrow morning. First down and 10. Braxton keeps it. And cannot get back to the line of scrimmage. That is a loss here.
And Braxton Miller is going to run the football, try to keep the clock moving. And, of course, he's going to have to deal with 44, Chris Borland. Chris Borland all over the field in every game for the Badgers. He's attacking downhill. Carlos Hyde is going to see Chris Borland in his nightmares tonight. He has been able to get off at 34 every single time, whether it's been pass protection or with Carlos is trying to block him to open up running lanes for Braxton Miller.
Second down and 12. Option look, hides the trailing back. Braxton keeps it. This will bring up third down. This, of course, the last time these two schools are going to play each other, because next year, two new divisions, East and West. Rutgers and Maryland join the Big Ten. And Ohio State will be in the East. Michigan will come with Michigan State, Penn State, and Indiana. And then, of course, you see Wisconsin goes over to Illinois, Iowa, Minnesota, Nebraska, Northwestern, and Purdue.
And don't look now. Rutgers beat Arkansas last week at home. They're still in the AAC. And Maryland's off to a great start.
Absolutely.
So people were really excited for what they're doing right now. East is very strong.
And lots of TV sets. They're down at 8 with Braxton Miller. Handing off now to Hyde, who bounces it outside, steps toward that first down marker for the Buckeyes.
Well, this is really great example of what Carlos Hyde can do. Bounces it right there. I mean, he has tremendous feet for his size. He's going to come up, it looks like, short of the first down. But he didn't give up on the play and just try to jam it in there for 2 or 3 yards. He bounced it to the outside. But he goes out of bounds, and the Badgers, after punting, what did they need? They needed a three and out. And they needed to get the ball back to Joel Stavi and see if they have a chance now under 5 minutes and they can get a touchdown.
Aberderis is back deep again, the sure-handed one. He's standing at about the 12-yard line on this fourth and short. Fair catch. Wraps it up. Makes sure at the 11-yard line. But again, Badgers are still down two scores. But it's their football when you come back to Columbus.
When it comes...
Last Wisconsin win at Columbus way back in 2001. Anthony Davis cut into a 17-point lead in the second quarter. And then Nick Davis caught this scoring pass from Brooks Bollinger in the third. That made it 17-14. And with the game tied late in the fourth, here came Mark Neuser. 33-yard field goal with 2 minutes left. Badgers win it at the Horseshoe.
Who was the Buckeye coach, Irby?
Jim Tressel, first year. Won the national title the very next year. Badgers always seem to play well in Columbus.
Not only do they need to play well, they need to play quickly. They're down two scores, and they've got 4:38 remaining. Sets the screen on first down with White. Good call. Upstairs, picking up 12 yards. Roby makes the tackle. First down and 10.
First down, of course, stops the clock, and it's a good call where Ohio State's pinning their ears. You can see them. They almost got to him, but because he gets it off, what a huge hit by Roby. You know, Roby's actually been better in run support and coming up to tackle folks than he has been in coverage tonight.
Stevie stepping up again. Incomplete and almost intercepted. He has thrown one interception, which resulted in a touchdown. Reminder to stay tuned after the game, except on the West Coast, for your late local news over most of these ABC stations. Be sure to turn to ESPN News for SportsCenter for the highlights of the day in sports.
Mustavi showed an ability to move his team down the field against Arizona State late. Of course, they had a controversial call, but he executed. He made some throws, found some people, so he's been in this kind of situation already this year.
Second and 10, firing. Everderis wraps it up again, but short of the first down. Everderis tonight has caught 8 balls for 171 yards and a touchdown.
And Ohio State has played a ton of man coverage tonight with Roby on Everderis. Now, because of the score of the game and the time of the game, playing some zone, trying to prevent the big play, and also trying, of course, to not give Mike Stavi have to read coverage.
Yeah, exactly, Irby. We saw him. Roby back off. Just keep him in front of him. Don't let him behind, as the Badgers secondary did late in the second quarter.
Number 49.
Well, Sam Arneson has had a rough night tonight. I don't know if the crowd's affecting him, but he's had a few of these false start penalties. It's his second one already in the game. And I think it's the miscues and the timing of the miscues for Wisconsin that has really hurt them.
He also made a fine touchdown.
He sure did. He got blown up and held onto the ball.
Third down and 9 for the Badgers. You got a 4-down clock for sure now. Don't need it. First down, Abraderis.
Does a good job of finding the hole in the zone, and then he gets down. He knows he's about to get hit by Joshua Perry. They know they're going to throw it to him here, but see how he gets down right before he's able to potentially be hit by 37.
Complete, Abraderis, but it was a whistle.
Timeout, Urban
Charge
Meyer.
Timeout, Ohio State. Their first timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
So Ohio State leading Wisconsin here by 10, 2:52 to go, and we await to see how many points the Ducks are going to score out on the West Coast. Clemson was very impressive.
Yeah.
today in that win over Wake.
Yeah, in Georgia, just because of who they've had to play this year and how they've been, you know, they went on the road against Clemson early, lost a close one, you and I were there, they beat South Carolina, and of course, ended up beating LSU. So it's a good point and a point that we talk about every week. It's not just early in this year about winning games. People are looking at to see how you look because they're comparing schedules. They're comparing, well, they only did this in that game. So every game you play in college football, as we know, matters.
Evanston next week.
That's going to be fun.
Okay.
I can't wait.
Wildcats. You know, Gary Barnett, the Northwestern coach, is working network radio here today as the analyst. And, of course, he led the Wildcats to the Rose Bowl back in 95 and was without his outstanding linebacker, Pat Fitzgerald, and guess what? Fitzgerald is now the coach.
That's right. When was the last time you called a game there?
I did a great... There's Gary Barnett. His arms are folded, standing next to the fellow with the binoculars who's spotting for Gary as he ages gracefully. I did a great Michigan-Northwestern game.
Remember that?
With late, I was working with Dan Fouts.
Anthony Thomas?
Okay, yeah, yes.
Bunch of overtime.
Yeah,
high
it was a terrific, terrific football game. And game day headed there? Is that what the thought is?
Yeah, I think it depends on what happens
here.
Hey,
I'll promise you, turnout with those young rascals. The Wildcats will be there. There's Aberderis out of bounds.
This time he put it up high for Aberderis. Reading the flat defender. See how the flat defender, Roby, just sits on the underneath route? Look, it's a huge hole behind it. An easy read and a good throw that time by Stavi. Put it up high to make it easier for Aberderis.
Stavi working the sideline a little bit too high.
Same route.
Herbie, your overall impression of Stavi tonight is 17 to 25, 277, two touchdowns at one time.
I think he's great. I could see why the coaches have fallen in love with his big arm. He's a sophomore. Let's remember that. He's still a young quarterback, 6'5", 225. He's going to get better and better. And I think the thing is, other than Jared Aberderis and the tight ends, they don't have a lot to work with out at wide receiver. It makes it very tough on him. But they put a great plan together to take the pressure off the running game.
Seems obvious that they're going to go down the stretch with White, let Gordon take the rest of the night off after he sustained that injury. And there they are showing to Erickson, and he's a redshirt freshman from Darlington, Wisconsin.
Wozniak went deep and took the linebackers with him. It opened up enough room there for the first down.
Incomplete. Came back to Wozniak that time.
It's no man's land. That's a tough catch. You know, to ask for a receiver, let alone a tight end. You know that a safety or a linebacker is going to close in on you in a hurry. And he may have heard some footsteps here. He starts to peek up. Christian Bryant's about to hit him.
Herbie, big answer by the front for the Buckeyes here tonight. Luke Fickell and the guys have done a good job. Badgers have rushed for only 104 yards. Remember, I think they were averaging about 350 yards a game coming into this. And they've been in the arena against Arizona State and Purdue. So the Buckeye front answered questions today. Grab and then dropped in the end zone. Incomplete pass for a moment. And that was Powell, the nickelback on defense here. Good job.
Yeah, Powell does a nice job. But I'll tell you, I think Erickson's going to start to emerge as maybe somebody to take some of the pressure off of Aberderis. But Powell, because of the location, the ball is thrown perfectly. Good concentration. But Powell and, of course, the Brown eventually dislodging the football. That's a freshman. Erickson trying to make a play there.
Before the snap.
Charge timeout. Ohio State. Their second timeout of the half. 30-second timeout.
Let's go quickly to Robert Flores. Robert.
All right, Brent, AT&T All-America Player of the Week nominee, Clemson quarterback Taj Boyd, 311 yards passing, three touchdowns. Also had another one on the ground as Clemson beat up Wake Forest 56-7. You can text VOTE to 34763. Brent.
All right, Robert, and the gang will be headed your way after the game. Reminder to stay tuned for the Ford wrap-up. This, by far, I guess, the best weekend in terms of competitive matchups and some surprises. Mississippi, after saying they could score on Alabama, They got big goose egg up there in Tuscaloosa. Maybe Nick Saban's finally happy with that defense.
You know, Brent, that timeout by Urban Meyer, you got to believe he's thinking of what can we do to Abradaris. Put a corner on him underneath, put a safety on him over top. You know they're going to try to look to get the ball to number four. And if you're Wisconsin, if you don't execute here, you're down 10. You got to think about maybe at least taking a shot at a field goal. Let's see what happens here.
There's no question.
Yeah.
Pressure. Incomplete. And here is the decision for Gary Anderson.
Yeah, you gotta
and
kick.
The Badgers, and you've got a kick here. You're down two scores. You don't even hesitate. On 4th and 10.
Yeah. He's got to do this, and he still has his 3 timeouts. And remember, French missed one earlier.
This is a 42-yarder, and this is from the left hash. Has he got it? He does indeed. Puts him within 1 score. A clutch field goal for the redshirt junior from Wisconsin. 31-24. Now your onside kick.
Well, you think about onside kick. You have 3 timeouts remaining.
Did you see the one onside kick in high school or college? I saw it on SportsCenter. The youngster came up and did the soccer, kicked it behind him, you know. And I said, whoa. And they recovered.
Did they?
Oh, yeah.
It was a little world.
The receiving team said, what's this? You know, right behind. Well, it was unbelievable.
I didn't see that.
Yeah, it was something. YouTube that, baby.
I will check that out.
Okay, there we are.
Well, we knew they'd have to throw. Stavi's delivered, and his guy, Abradaris, 10 receptions, 207 yards. This isn't a fluke with Abradaris. Stavi's done everything he can. Even when Ohio State has known that Abradaris is going to get the football, he still has been able to make plays and kept the Badgers in this game. They're down a touchdown. 1 possession game.
Good hands, folks, on the field for the Bucks. Can't overload one side, remember. Must travel 10 yards. So Andrew Endicott, a freshman, is going to kick this off. And Kyle French, let me check this. They go to Kyle French. Pooches it. Roby on a bounce, tapped out of bounds.
That was almost
I
was, Chris Borland is down on the, trying to cover this, and they go the other way. Roby,
he touched that ball.
He sure did.
I mean, and of course, it traveled 10 yards if the Badgers could have recovered it inbounds, but that ball has been touched now by Roby and out of bounds.
Yeah, he touched the ball without a doubt.
The ball was touched by Ohio State prior to going out of bounds. Please reset the game clock for 2:03. It will be Ohio State's ball, 1st and 10.
Well, now he's got 3 timeouts. He's going to assume that Urban Meyer is going to run the football 3 times, and they've got to try to come up with a stop. How about the English on this ball? If he doesn't get a hand on that, it bounces right back towards the coverage team.
Luke Fickell.
See, back to number 10. 1st down.
Ohio State's thinking about 1 first down. Wisconsin's thinking 3 and out with 3 timeouts. Get the ball back and see if they can see if they have a chance.
Ohio State's the ball. 1st and 10 at their own 34.
You can see the 2 tight end formation. Power game with Hyde. And he muscles. A few yards on 1st down. And now the clock has stopped on that timeout. Well, LSU, Georgia. A high-scoring, high-flying football game, and the Dogs hold on and win it. Bama shuts out Ole Miss, a team that bragged all week that they could score on. And Clemson mauls Wake Forest.
What are you talking about?
Why are they sending those tweets out for? What was that all about?
Oh, man.
There's the two quarterbacks in that SEC showdown. Both played awfully well. 44-41, 85 points put up down in between the hedges in Athens. And Kirby is most impressed by the Dogs and their resume right now, so we'll see how high they jump. Second down and six.
Game's coming down to 6 yards here on these next two plays.
Tough on tough. High snap. Braxton recovers it, but is going to be thrown for a loss.
Another timeout for Wisconsin. Boy, that's exactly what the Badgers needed. I don't know if that surprised Braxton Miller. Let's take another look at it. High snap. He could have been able to make the play. Boy, Wisconsin's thinking about that ball getting by him and recovering it. Buckeyes fortunate that Braxton Miller was able to at least get a hand on it, went up in the air, and then be able to secure it. And actually got back to making it third down and 10. Now you're Urban Meyer, you're Tom Herman. And you know that Wisconsin has the one timeout left. And you got a junior quarterback who's a three-year starter. Has ability to, if he likes a pass, he can throw it. If he doesn't like it, he can pull it down and improvise and, at the very least, just get down. Do you take a chance or do you just run it, make them use their last timeout, punt it away?
Well, you keep the clock running if you run it.
Of course.
And you bring it down around 145, 144.
But maybe you give them the option that, hey, if this receiver's open, take it. If not, just eat it.
He's a long way now. They need a full 10 yards here, Harvey. There is Braxton, though, lining up alone back there.
There's an empty receiver. Hey, Wisconsin's confused.
Braxton gonna bounce outside if he can. He's surrounded. And now the Buckeyes will punt it away with 1:40 on the clock. So the Badgers exhaust their timeouts. We can take a look at the top 10. We've already mentioned those teams. Jockeying. Oregon out 27-0. A light rain falling in Eugene, we are told. Clemson with a big win. Ohio State trying to hang on here. Stanford up 17-3. LSU, of course, is going to fall. Louisville was idle. Florida State, hats off to Boston College. What a game they played today against the Noles. They made the Noles reach deep. Georgia with that impressive win. Texas A&M and Johnny Football, 45-33 over Arkansas. And former Wisconsin coach Brett Bielema. Fourth down and six. Everderis will come in. So remember back early when we wondered if Gary Anderson would punt it away? He did. And now he's going to get... Beautiful punt. Everderis is driven back. Catches it. Shakes a would-be tackler. And is down at the 10-yard line. 1:29 and no timeouts. And, of course, another reminder about the NASCAR tomorrow at Dover. Matt Kenseth, 2 for 2 in the chase. Trying to hold on to that lead. Jimmy Johnson lurking. They're at Dover tomorrow, 1 p.m. Eastern on ESPN.
Remember, talked earlier about how Stavi and this offense, they've been put in this situation early in the year against Arizona State. They've been in earlier this game. No timeouts. Now it's about first downs and trying to get out of bounds. And Ohio State wants to keep Wisconsin in bounds to keep that clock moving.
First down. Tipped. Incomplete. Second and 10.
Great pressure from Ohio State. Shazier got in there. And I don't know if this made the ball go through it a little bit behind Erickson. Ryan Shazier was closing in on him in a hurry. The last thing that Stavi knows he can do without any timeouts is take a sack. But he also has to be careful trying to force a football into coverage.
Able to shovel it off to White, who fumbles the ball, and it is pounced on by the quarterback.
Over the clock,
Joel Stavi with the clock running. That's and right. The third down coming up here.
Wisconsin.
He's going to have to hurry and get it up there.
Remember the Arizona State game? It was the ref's fault, but also there wasn't enough urgency from Wisconsin. Stavi, have you learned from that urgency? They got to get to the line of scrimmage. They don't have any timeouts. Get it together on the field here. Wasting time.
Third and 17. Stavi drops it off underneath to White.
Clock's
White is short.
Still
clock still running, and they've got a fourth down coming up.
This is really poor execution by Wisconsin here. A Buckeye player of all things goes down at the bottom of the screen. Christian Bryant.
That stops the clock.
Yep. Well, they had Wisconsin on the ropes there after that almost sack and then the fumble. And then they kind of looked around at each other, and the clock's going tick, 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 tick. But the only thing that could have allowed Wisconsin to regroup was something like this, an injury.
So I'm going to take you back, Herbie, but you come along now to the end of that Arizona State game. One of the worst pieces of officiating I'd seen in a long time. Goes to center, and he gives it up. You kill the clock when you give it up. Instead, Arizona State yells fumble. Well, you kill it right there. Even if you thought it was a fumble, you send it up to instant replay. They never kill it. And the Badgers run out of time. They're denied a chance to win that game.
For some reason.
Holy terrible decision.
That was a mess.
It was awkward when he went down, but if you look for the end zone, he did indeed make impact with the knee, but that doesn't matter. If you give it up, it's over. Now tonight, now he's on the officials. Get them off the ball. Get the Buckeyes back up.
Well, the Wisconsin players as well, they've got to have some urgency themselves.
He's on the side, Judge. Get him off that football.
You go back to that play, and you know, it was Ohio State's trying to come up with a fumble, and they're chasing James White. The ball's on the ground. But what I'm talking about is right now, boom, you got to get up. You got to get up. Even if you're a lineman, pick them up. If you think they're laying on top of your player, just has to be a built-in clock. You got to know after a play like that, you don't have a timeout. You got to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Fourth down. Need three, 26 seconds. Incomplete. The Buckeyes win.
Jumps that route. Looked like Duckworth may have let that ball slip through his hands, but that was pretty good coverage and nice quickness here by Duran Grant.
So we found out what Urban Meyer intended to do with the quarterback situation. This is Braxton Miller's team. I want to win the game. We're going the distance with him. And Urban Meyer is going to move to 17-0 as the head coach at Ohio State. Goes over to shake hands with Gary Anderson, who once worked with him as a defensive line coach out of Utah. The longest win streak in the country. Stanford hoping to push theirs to 12 tonight. Alabama already a winner. Northwestern's off this week. We'll see them next week against Ohio State. Let's go down now to Heather Cox with Urban Meyer.
Urban, it seems like every year in this series, the games are always close. Tonight was no different. Ultimately, what do you think the difference was?
Well, we stopped the run. You know, that kind of team, they're a very talented team. Number 25 and 20 are two of the best backs that we'll see. And not just this year, or, you know, for the next couple of years. I think they're really good. We stopped the run. We gave up far too many yards passing. We'd like to close the game a little better, but we'll take them, man, 5-0.
Absolutely. And there's so much talk coming into this game that was really being billed as your first true test of the season. What did you learn about your team tonight?
Well, we passed the test. We won the game. And against a very good team, against a ranked opponent. Let's go on to try to get number 6.
And Braxton Miller came back. Ultimately, what do you think he meant to this team in his return?
Oh, he's a talented guy. He ran and threw. He did a nice job, man. Nice job. He's a great player and played well.
Absolutely. We'll talk to your quarterback. Urban, thank you so much. Braxton, welcome back. What did it feel like to finally be back on the field tonight?
I'm just blessed to give all the glory to God, man, just be back, able to play with my teammates. And, you know, we fought hard throughout the day. That's a good defensive team, man. We had a good scheme, and worked out pretty good.
And tonight you passed some, you ran some, you even blocked some. How did that knee hold up?
Man, it felt good. I told him I was going to get a chop block, so it felt pretty good, man. They was hyped for me and everything, so it was a good win.
Will you continue to wear that brace in the future?
Oh, yeah. I'll show you what. Yeah. I got to take care of that.
We talked yesterday quite a bit about it's not only the return for you, but also for Carlos Hyde and how excited you were to play with your running back. How did the team gel with the two of you back on the field together for the first time this year?
It felt like last year, man. You know, we ain't miss a beat. And it just felt good having those back there, you know, get a couple carries. And he blocked good, so we came out with a good win. And just thankful for God.
Impressive performance out there, Braxton. Welcome back.
Thank you.
Thanks,
Heather. And so, Herbie, there you have it. The Buckeyes win by 7, but they did give up 10 fourth-quarter points. And I don't think Urban Meyer was happy about being outscored in the fourth quarter.
Right. You can almost tell from his attitude there with Heather that there's, you go back to the film room, you try to get better. It's a win, 31-24 against the gritty Wisconsin team. Buckeyes hit some big plays early in the passing game, the 4 touchdowns, of course, from Braxton Miller. Anytime you can learn from a victory, you're happy as a head coach, and they'll try to get better as they go on the road next week to Evanston to take on the Wildcats.